Welcome to Unsportsmanlike Podcast. I'm Lee Kelly, and with me is Jack Curry and special guest Darren Mitchell. How are you doing, guys?
Spot on.
Fantastic, mate. How are you?
Not too bad. Pretty tired and pretty hot right now. There's a lot of heat in the air.
Body heat, mate.
Probably the hot winds.
Possibly.
So, we've got a bit of a wild podcast today. Our first special guest and our second in-person podcast. As you can see, our setup has changed somewhat, thanks to Lee. We've now actually got our jerseys on the wall, which is quite good. Really annoying that Lee hasn't got his name at the front, but
it is. Want the logo.
You've got the logo. It is what it is. Today we obviously have our old head coach, now chairman of the Darlington Steam.
Is it old in
old,
age?
Old specifically.
Old age.
Like, well, he has been doing this since I was 15.
There is that.
Yeah, that's right. I was 16. Like, this guy, he shaved his hair today so that you couldn't see the greys.
Yeah, fair enough.
And as you can see, he's all white hoodie, just like Gandalf the White.
What? First time wearing it, yeah.
It's a great birth.
And you know what it is, right? He got the big KFC bucket, wore his white hoodie, and then got gravy, representing Team North with that gravy.
Northern boys love gravy.
So, obviously we've got Darren with us, and we were hoping today, Darren, that you might be able to shed some light on recent activities with the Darlington Steam. We've had a lot of changes, and me and Lee have obviously talked about it, but since then, we have a new acquisition at the club, so it would be quite great if you could tell us a little bit about it.
I'll give you a rundown.
Why this strip?
Yeah, well, the first move was me. Was me stepping down, which needed to happen, unfortunately. Doing the same thing for 10 years was, it got to the point where burnout happens. I'm sure there's coaches out there that can sympathise with that. But it, what it's done is allowed us to revitalise the club a little bit, in my opinion, both on and off the field, which was what was needed. So it was, me stepping away has allowed me to appoint a new head coach. Who's got, like, as in the press release where it's aligned with our values and stuff like that. Obviously the Steam have got a way of doing things like every team do, so we had to bring someone in who was going to carry on the work that I'd put in and the other coaches and the committee and everything, but someone was going to help push it that little bit further as well. So yeah, that's when we end up appointing Adam Wilgan as our new head coach. Coming over from Gateshead Centre's Academy, where he done awesome work with the youth and junior program over there, one of the best, if not the best, in the country.
Still think Woodham was better. That's a debate, I suppose.
Anyway, win a final.
So you
can't even say that shit. Well, can you even?
I've said the same thing for years.
You can't even shoot that. We didn't win a final.
There you go.
We won more playoff games at Woodham in our first year than Darlow did in their first 10.
That's fine. Did you ever finish first?
I finished second a lot.
So that's first loser.
We know a lot about that.
It's been a ride.
So, as you probably alluded behind the scenes and to the club stuff like that, how long did it take you to replace yourself?
3 days. Actually, no, 3 hours.
3 hours.
3 hours. I work quick.
That's like he had it planned or something.
Yeah. Could be.
No, not me.
He wouldn't plan shit, would he?
I don't do things like that.
He does. He fucking does. Everyone who knows him from anywhere, whether it's like another sport or whether it's actual football, and you've known Darren for the last couple of years, this guy fucking, he plans his whole morning. He planned this fucking... He already knew what the menu we were going to get when we got to KFC. He was like, party bucket. I was like, are you sure? He was like, yes.
It's more of a lineman than you, Jack.
100%. You've definitely got to plan the food. That's essential, do you know what I mean? Well, yeah.
So, yeah, talking on your role, or I was going to say new role, but more of an extended role now, as chairman, what are some of the things that you're planning to do with the club to push it forward in the meantime, like
short term just to make sure that the first team, because we're going to go away from calling it adult contact, we want to call it the firsts,
Darlington Steam A, Team A.
Well, eventually it will be,
because we already know that there's a team that me and Lee have spoke about, London Blitz, who have a team A, well, the London Blitz, and then Team B, which we already think, and as you'll probably know, because you probably watch our podcasts, that they should go to the London Olympians, and then London Olympians have become great again. Just a suggestion for London Blitz.
So just to keep Brian Sheehan happy.
Yes.
But yeah, no, for the Blitz sort of thing, it's getting to the point where it's looking like they're probably going to end up in the Premiership as well, just with how decent they're doing. That's why we brought it up mainly.
Yeah, well, you've got to think of the pool of people that you've got to choose from. I mean, I know there's a lot of teams in London, but London's a big place compared to Downton. Do you know what I mean? It's, yeah, I mean, our, at the circle that we hunt from is like, we hunt from. But like you've got Darlow, and then you've got Richmond and Catterick. So you've got the Catterick Garrison, which you've got a couple of squaddies on our team due to that. Then you've got the likes of Middlesbrough, Stockton, Yarm, you know, we've even got players in York. So the catchment area is quite big for us compared to some of the others, because some of the others have, they've got teams where they just squash together. So
yeah, definitely. I know one thing, have you seen the map with North versus South Conference? Where the line is drawn.
Yeah, I know.
It's insane.
Yes, it is. It is.
I still don't understand how that works.
Leeds is...
Neither does Baffert.
Baffert don't know.
Baffert just making stuff up.
Leeds is south to us, though. Do you know what I mean?
Well, yeah, it's south to us, but at least it's not like what Bristol is almost in the North Conference.
Are they?
Yeah, they were. It's like... So it's Cornwall and all that, and it's like a bit of Wales, and like...
Is it because Bristol's in Prem? There's two Bristol teams, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apache and Aztecs. Aztecs are the Div 1, and Apache are Div... No,
Apache are Div 1, because they've
Div
got...
Div 1 and Div 2, they're not
and then
Prem.
They got pushed up, didn't they?
Aztecs are Prem.
Yeah.
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 That was a KFC burp, sorry. No, sorry.
Thanks.
Switch off, wait till the end of the podcast.
This room's gonna be brutal.
Yes, it is.
Have to air it out.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Anyway, sorry for interrupting you, Darren. Mm-hmm. Tell us about your first team, Darlington's team plan.
No, so you've got the first. It's they're obviously now in Division One, so it's cementing the season, really, seeing the season through. Obviously, we've got a new head coaching, like as obviously said, and you know there'll be new players hopefully joining soon. And then once we've done that, then we can focus on the academy. Now, the short term is just getting the youth going, which obviously you're runningly. Is making sure that gets back in the league, because unfortunately when it was associated for the obvious reasons. Yeah. I mean, having that many juniors, that many youth players going into junior age, it was over 2/3 of the squad, and you know you're gonna suffer.
I think multiple teams have had that sort of issue as well.
I agree, yeah.
Really for the youth.
Mm-hmm.
But Northeast Academy is as well in our area, and obviously Centres has had issues with garages. So that's
the centres only had issues because the Centres made issues.
True, but it just in general, there's three teams there which are in the North, which aren't in there for this division, which is insane. Unless Baffer does something,
Baffer needs to do something, because you right now you've got the champions sitting there doing nothing. So that's a bit of a killer. You got all this talent, and because of, fair enough, some things that happened with their head coach, who weirdly is now our head coach, some things happened with him, and then behind the scenes, and then his actual team didn't support them, and now where they are.
Yeah, I know, but I mean,
the championship squad now just gone.
It is,
and they've lost the head coach to that championship squad. How now they're rebuilding.
I mean, only they know the reason why that's happened. But the thing is, if now that Adam's with us, you know, their loss could be our gain, but that's going to be the, you know, time's going to sort that out.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Because I think some players are going to try it, because they'll want a season, especially those that are in their last year or junior.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to get that with us this year.
Yeah.
So you're going to find that some of them probably go to Giants, possibly York. Do you know what I mean? Depends upon who do the travel. But, you know, and I don't blame them for doing that, because keep playing football, because who wouldn't? You know what I mean? Especially at that age.
So I don't know a lot about youth football in the UK right now.
Yeah.
You have a choice. Giants or Rams, or what would they call down south?
Assassins.
You've got Leeds. Giants or Assassins.
Mm-hmm.
Who do you go to?
I think it's the Assassins for the under-19s, is it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Because the Rams is the
Yeah. So as it goes, which one's the best team? Where do you, either way, say you're at Gateshead. Gateshead, you go up to Northumberland, you might have to drive like half an hour or something like that. And driving to York, it's like an hour and a half. What do you do? And but who's better? So
the better team out of the two, are we on about under-19s or under-16s?
Under-16s and then under-19s?
Under-16s.
If you're 15-year-old, where you wanting to play?
16s will probably, if they want to play this full season, will
be the Assassins. Giants can't play.
And in the season either, they only have 5.
So players. We say so right now...
They're in the same predicament as us, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got... They've had a lot of players moving up to junior.
And they had a bigger squad than us last year as well.
They did, yeah.
Which is insane how many people...
Big lads play for them, like.
So you could argue that Assassins are about to win... under 16s this year.
Not necessarily.
Depends on South, really.
Hmm?
Depends on South, really.
Yeah.
But who's in there? Who's in the under 16s division? There's Assassins, Alphas. And Alphas have got a good up and coming youth team.
I've been watching a lot of stuff from the Alphas.
Good organization.
It's really good. Who's the head coach again?
I think there's 6 or 7.
Their youth team?
I don't know.
I think there's 6 or 7 teams in the actual.
Is that it?
And because they've reorganized it, so last year they had like 12 teams.
Sheffield Giants have come up.
Yeah, to that one.
Overall, or just in the north.
So they've So it's like how they've done with the adults. They reorganized everything, so they've got a smaller divisions for each place.
Yeah.
But it's more localized.
Right.
So it's a lot less travel, but they've also got the 2 games per thing now instead of 3 as they had last year.
So you've got to think for the Northeast League. Senators didn't make it.
Yeah.
Steam didn't make it. North East Giants didn't make it.
And the Warriors didn't make it either.
Sleep.
All I'm saying is 2011 Warriors would beat any of these youth teams.
Wilkins gonna open a beauty argument over that one.
I know. I've already spoken about it. I think 2011 Warriors had talent, we just didn't have the scope to hit what his players have done and go to the USA.
What were the Warriors missing?
Warriors, what were they missing?
They must have been missing some. What was the one thing that separated them from finishing runners up to being overall champions, national champions? What was it?
The first team we went up against in our first final was the London Warriors.
Mm-hmm.
So you got the Wooden Warriors in Newton Aycliffe, a place that no one even knew about.
Yeah.
Going up against London Warriors, as we just discussed before, who had the scope of all of London.
Mm-hmm.
In the second final, we went up against Highland Wildcats.
Yeah.
And we already know that Highland this year especially made a big splash. And
the Wildcats have always had a good system.
What the Wildcats had is a defensive tackle called Davey Grant,
who
currently plays for them now.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just a beast. And he went to play Team Europe the year before I did. Like, he was insane.
Did you play for Team Europe, mate?
I didn't. I played for FBU Team Europe. Sorry, just thought I'd tell you. Dickhead. Why do we invite this frick on the podcast? Fuck you. I lost my train of thought now. What were we missing?
They actually haven't...
Yes.
We weren't missing shit, man.
They haven't released it yet.
So why... There's... When you're going up against someone in a final, there's got to be something that's not...
All our games were a touchdown.
Right, okay.
There was never a blowout. I think our Highland one came down to literally a last second touchdown at Highland Court on Jordan Mannion. Never let him live that one down. He broke coverage and turned around. The guy had caught it with 1 foot in. Insane. The first one was against London Warriors, but they just had like a massive running back. It was just like, you put your fat lad in because no one can tackle a fat lad.
Right.
They just kept pounding it down the field. It was like, how do you stop these guys? Because they're insane. And we had some of the best. That was our first year. We had some mid-tacklers there, like some absolute athletes. And then the last one, we had a... I'm not. It's no excuse, but there was thunder and lightning, so they had to stop the game for like an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone was fucked. And the London Warriors had a bigger squad than us. So when it came back to play and we're all aching, like, I got knocked out in that game. I got knocked clean out. I just remember opening my eyes and like, are you all right? I was like, yeah. I'm all right.
Put me in, coach.
Took off for a player. I was like, if you think I ain't going back onto this field, you are mistaken. This is my last chance to win a championship. I'm going back out there.
Mm.
So, but that's it. They were all like literally last touchdowns that we missed. So
it was close.
That's what it comes down to between they say it's a game of inches. That's the difference between being a runner up and being a national champion.
Yeah.
Just go back for the alignment stuff. They haven't released the under-16s yet. They've just, they've only, well, only towards the end of February, they only released the under-19s, which...
Darren's getting on the phone to Baffa right now.
It's made up of...
Yeah. Baffa. Where is it? No. 2 seconds, I might have the alignment.
I don't know if we can say that yet.
2 second break while Darren ruins the U16 league.
It's been released.
For the under-19s, you got Senators, East Kilbride, Napier Knights, Manchester Titans, and Charlie Buccaneers for the North. Which, well, Senators probably aren't in there. Which, don't know what's going to happen.
Big up the Charlie Buccaneers. Coach Nicholson has a... Is Coach Nicholson still in charge of Charlie?
He is. Good guy.
They're going to fucking win. 100%. I got my money on Charlie Buccaneers to win the whole thing.
Seems like London Blitz won.
You go. Naturally.
That's...
Lee's about to hit some...
allowed to release that?
I don't know.
Just some spoilers. Okay. Spoiler alert. If you don't want to know what's happening, or you feel like you might get...
If you're from Baffa, don't listen to this next one.
If you're from Baffa and you're watching this podcast,
wouldn't it be released otherwise?
I don't think they're released because they usually release
it. Please, everyone.
On the news, I know that you just check what the email says, like see if it says do not release this yet. It usually says something like that. But
chairman,
it just seems like
bitch.
I'm just trying not get any punishments from Baffa for releasing something early. All I know is it seems like half the people in the conference...
It doesn't say we can't.
I'm just saying, I'll do a find.
So it doesn't say we can't. Just go on, just talk about the East. Just talk about the one we would have been in, which would have been not the East. No, we're not in Scotland.
Right, yeah.
Shit.
So, what?
There's only 3 teams there.
Oh, that's a new one. So in the East, it would be Sheffield Giants, Gunthorpe Alphas, Yorkshire Academy Assassins for the East Northern Conference. So it's got Giants, Senators, and
Steam
taken out of that. So
mm-hmm. And the Giants have been shifted in.
Yeah, they've shifted in from West, was it? They were probably in West.
Probably.
So yeah.
I'm not a part of this Baffa. I'm really not a part of this.
Where the Wooden Warriors?
Zoom in.
It's literally engraved in history.
You've got to go back to like 2008, yeah.
Hey, look, at the end of the day, right, we have a lot of Wooden Warriors who play for us who have given me, as a head coach, they give me everything they had playing for me. Do you know what I mean? So, hats off to the Wooden.
And that's the end of the podcast. That's all I needed to hear. I'll have that on loop for the rest of the week.
So, yeah. So, we've talked about the short term now. What's your plans for the future?
Huh. Right. So
should have brought some popcorn.
No. So
we've got popcorn chicken.
Yes. I want to anyway. I wanna have the cadets going. So cadet flag. You enjoy now? Watch your fingers. I want cadet flag, youth.
Ooh. One more thing.
Now, I've had to babysit these for 10 years and it's gotten changed.
I'm a really bad quarterback. Everyone knows. No, you're not looping, you meant to power it in. Oh, that was going in. Fucking lobbing up your head.
Anyway.
Sorry, Lee.
So, yes, we want cadet flag. We want youth, junior. And then you want the firsts. Then I want adult flag back. And then, hopefully, because I've been approached quite a lot about it, a women's team, all right. And on top of that, I want to get pre-cadet. No, I want pre-cadet where it's just where you don't run half-term stuff and all that. You know, after school clubs.
Charlie have one of these, don't they?
Yeah. So
yeah.
I wish. God, I'd be mid. No, it'd be a full-on peewee football. We could, but we might get sued. But still, you know what I mean. Baffa wouldn't be happy.
Oh, fuck Baffa. We'll that's what this whole podcast is about.
We'll go with the
UK. I can't say that because then we're getting fined.
The AFL or whatever it is.
Yeah.
I'm going to see you talking about
we'll just contact the NFL, see if they want to start a Pee Wee League.
Yeah. No, but I mean, you've got, if you can get the kids in at a young age,
yeah,
it's, you're already starting the pathway. And it's not just to get them to the first team, it's to get them to the likes of, you want them to go up the stage, you want them to give these kids opportunities, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And as I've always said, what you're in it for? Are you enjoying yourself? Seriously, man, honestly. Don't guest on his podcast.
Sorry, yeah. Carry on. I'm listening.
So the eventual aim for all of this is, if the player puts in enough effort and shows off qualities, that they can get to the States, essentially.
Yeah.
And with guidance of Adam, as I would say, like, help coordinate it as a whole,
mm-hmm.
to be able to bring up the kids in such a scenario that it gives them the opportunity to do that. And he's had multiple players under him,
mm-hmm.
go to the States already.
Yeah, well, one's just signed up to go to high school, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Mighty Morgan. Congratulations.
Does not look like an under 16 when he's playing.
Though. Huge.
Well done.
What a player he is, by the way.
Which guy is this?
Mighty Morgan, wide receiver, outstanding.
I'm talking about Hassan.
We got Hussein over there and Josh Wakes over there.
He definitely didn't look like an under 16 when
Who was this one?
He looked like an adult playing under 16.
Oh, Hussein.
He's going to look great as silver.
Like Cam Newton. Like 7 foot tall.
So what's happening there?
Yeah, tell our viewers.
With what?
You just said he'll look great in silver.
Well,
what team's he going to?
Wooden Warriors, yeah.
Yeah. I want to give him Jack's old top.
Bring it back.
No, that's just me just pitching that out. Do you know what I mean? We are getting three new signings, which we've signed today. So
who are the new signings?
So we've got Kieran Park. He was a defensive lineman who was with Adam's under-19s team.
Dog.
He is a beast. What a player. He was at Team GB. He was at...
Team North, represent.
He was at Team North, yeah. And he was he'd done a year or two of Filton as well.
Love Filton pride.
He's a player. Great acquisition. And then we've got Adam Hughes, who's coming from Gated Senior Team. He was a centre.
Dog.
Highly experienced player, great leadership qualities. I've supported Jock for years, and he's a good player to bring in, not just the footballing ability, it's the, like I say, it's the leadership to bring the rookies on. And then the third one's what I call Corey Pearson. He was a linebacker / defensive back.
Dog.
Yeah, so he's a bit of a hybrid, like a nickel. Well, yeah, because that's what you do. Yeah, but that's what you do at youth and junior. You teach them everything.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? You just have these utility players if you want. Yeah, that's what you want to build. Do you know what I mean? So there's the third. That's the first three players that are going to join up.
Get quarterback who's not afraid to run the ball.
Hmm?
Get a quarterback who's not afraid to run the ball.
Oh, Josh can run it.
I'm not saying that Josh can't run. I'm just saying get a quarterback who just will truck it like a running back.
Yeah, I would picture Josh as more of a pocket passer.
Yeah.
He's not afraid to run it. That's not what I was saying, but I'm just saying in general. Just as a whole.
Like you're saying.
What do you mean?
He's a running back.
He's a tight end, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he is in the States. He's playing tight end.
He wouldn't be afraid to run it. Like, he wouldn't be afraid, like, quite
no,
a
not
lot
at all.
Of QBs might be afraid to
no.
get well, out of the pocket.
But currently, he's registered with the Senate, so I can't really talk about what another team's playing now, can I?
No, we can't. Well, we can, because we're on a podcast. It's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Like on a player.
We can.
We're allowed to do this.
Yeah, you can, yeah.
What are they going to do? They're going to beat me at Division 2.
Well, you know what I mean. It's,
Sorry, I actually think Gates is going to do well this season.
I hope they all do
no,
well.
No disrespect. Only a little bit.
What about Wakefield?
It's the best team in Wakey.
Yeah,
Wakey Raiders.
Not only, they surprised me last year, but unfortunately not in a good way. I thought they were going to be better than they were. If I was honest, the preparation that went into the game to make for us to play them, which was it was a tasty game, decent first half. But I don't know.
It was filthy, the first game.
Yeah, it was, but we like that type of game. Oh, everyone likes it. That's American football.
I loved it, but I just didn't like
it. It's Division II football.
All the accusations that followed.
Well, yeah, but they got cleared, so I'm not really asked.
I just remember the smell from that day.
The smell? Yeah.
What smell?
Just the sideline smell, that's all.
Like blood. Lee walked under the walked under the sideline, and all he could smell was fucking blood and fear.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. I actually rate not only quite high and think they're gonna do well this season.
I think they'll do all right. No, I think they'll do all right in Div 2. I mean, they might have a bit. I don't know if they've signed any more players from that Yorkshire Rams and Leeds Bobcats merger.
They'll probably do well this season, like in comparison to last season.
They'll be competing against Gateshead.
They'll be up there. They'll be there when Gateshead.
Division 2, that league looks all right. Humber a decent team.
It looks so fucking. We talked about how we would rather watch them this season.
Doncaster's issue is a bit like DC's. They need to make all the games. They weren't making them last year. Do you know what I mean?
I think there's more emphasis on and actually more presence behind actually making them now, so they can get that money back though. Because if they don't make one of the games, then they lost out £500, which.
Oh yeah, they put £500 like a deposit.
It's all changed now. It's all about money.
Don't get me started on that.
But yeah, no, I think it's actually a decent shout to actually so they can try and at least make the games rather than just flake out.
Yeah. It was too easy, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, pre COVID, it was a bit harder with the yellow red card system.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But since COVID, it's only really coming this year with the £500.
Sorry, but isn't it weird how COVID's gone?
Has it?
Not really. I just got some COVID tests through the door today.
And?
I mean, like, they just gave me some. They just posted some through the door.
Oh, okay. How'd you do?
To be fair, though, because he's critically ill, that's what.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
Yes.
Lee doesn't really work from home. He's locked in this room. Is Mrs. Lee's food on the
this
bottom
is actually,
step?
This is actually quarantine, and he's just making the most of it.
This table goes down and then I put the mattress on top.
It's not even wrong. This leftover KFC is getting left for him. He's not going to get fed for the next 3 days.
That's my supper.
Yeah.
Supper, breakfast and lunch.
Light snack. 11. It's almost 11. what were we talking about? Not only.
I don't know. It's gone a bit haywire.
It hasn't.
It's wakey.
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 They should get that on the helmets.
Oh, the space
like
raiders.
Like the wakey raiders. Space raiders.
I hope you have a banner as you're walking in, what's the best team in wakey. Like, seriously.
Well,
they've
been posting a hell of a lot on Facebook about that.
They'd be active.
Just joining in.
They have to. They've got an opportunity here to literally push their team on a social media scale.
Yeah, because it went viral. The whole wakey thing went viral.
And now
I hope they get sponsored by it. They just make it better.
Because now you can go, who's the best team in Div 2? Wakey Raiders.
That's it.
Amazing.
I hope the Wakey guys running on with Prime. Do you know what I mean? Go to the team, don't want one of these for £100.
That guy sponsors them. Yeah. I actually heard that his shop got raided recently.
It did, yeah.
To be fair, his past is actually quite a lot of drug dealing stuff.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
As well as a few other things. And I think he's had some court cases with... threats of violence
to every person who walks into his shop. He's like, please. Yeah, he doesn't even say please. He just says,
those people haven't actually bought it.
Exactly. Like, he says,
you can leave if you buy this frame.
He just robs them and then gives them a bottle and says,
you bought this.
You bought this for £150, didn't you? Yeah. Of course.
That's his alibi.
You've seen it now. They bought it.
They were willing.
By the way, everyone in those videos, if it is a legitimate video, all those people are fucking stupid to actually go there and pay that much money for a low-key level energy
drink.
That's
what parents do for the kids.
I tell you now.
It's not even.
Well, you can ask Matu, that wouldn't happen.
It's not an energy drink.
It's just a drink.
Yeah, it doesn't even hydrate you.
But, with that being said, it's got 2 calories in, 2 grams of sugar. Oh, sorry, we're there. This is not a promotion. Okay. No.
To be fair, they are sponsoring teams. They
drink,
sponsor
drink
a random
Pepsi.
Non-league team down in down south.
A random non-league team.
Yeah.
Non-league American football team.
Non-league normal soccer.
Can you imagine if it was like a non-league
Don't
American?
Don't call it soccer in England. Soccer.
Oh, here we go.
I'm more American now than British.
You've married him.
He's married an American. He's got a half American daughter. Yeah.
Maybe you're English.
We're literally, this house
I
is...
I speak more American than I do English.
This house is in the state of Nebraska. Legally.
It's now part of the US.
Uh-huh.
God damn, I've paid taxes now.
Did you not see LeBee's right to hand over as I came through the door?
Is that what it was?
And then the KFC tax to get in.
Yeah. import tax. If you get any benefits from this podcast, you'll pay it to the US government as well.
100%, yeah. Fuck the USA.
I've been able to help do this.
Sorry, America.
I've been able to help the wife with doing her taxes for this year, because it's a pain in the ass. You still have to file them, even though she's not a citizen. She's a citizen, she just doesn't live there.
So what should you do? Zero?
So it's zero, but you still
have to file. I bet that was difficult.
it's about 12 pages of paperwork.
And that's just writing zeros?
Essentially. You've got to put your actual salary in, because there's a taxation thing is where if you earn above $112,000, that's where you got to pay tax to the US as well.
Bastards.
So it's fine for her because she's not earning that, but you still got to file your taxes.
It's ridiculous.
And you can get fined if you don't file them on time. And here's a kicker. If you want to not be a US citizen, you have to, and you want to renounce your citizenship, you have to have all your taxes all up to date, otherwise you get fined as well.
Yeah.
Sorry.
But you also have to pay about $3,000 to leave being a US citizen, to actually be off it, and you're not allowed to say you're leaving it because of tax reasons.
With that being said, if anyone's considering leaving the Downton Steam, same rules apply.
Absolutely.
All up to date on your taxes.
This is something I'm bringing in.
Oh, fucker.
Leaving fee.
Yeah. Severance.
Anyway, moving on. What's some of your highlights at the Steam?
Start from like.
What do you want, like my top five?
Top five of moments. And I know
in order.
Order them if you
fucking
want.
Rights, yeah.
And then your least favorite.
Yeah.
Where's the wiper?
Right, okay. So, let me think. Fifth.
I love talking, by the way, everyone, so buckle in.
Yeah. We'll ask him about his breakfast soon.
Yeah.
Did I have any this morning?
Did you have breakfast?
I didn't have breakfast this morning.
Me neither. I had a Sunday roast left over. I had that about 11 o'clock.
I had a cookie. I had a cookie that I cooked last night at about 2 a.m.
You're spoiling yourself again.
Just one.
He's only allowed out of the attic at about 12 o'clock when everyone goes to bed.
He's asleep.
Yes, we're back in before 3 o'clock.
Right, let's have a thing. Fifth will have been.
Will have been.
Whatever. Fifth, I'm trying to think, so I'm trying to put them in order. You're enjoying yourself. For the first time you're stuck on the bone, is it?
No!
Boom, boom.
That's what happens after games all the time.
I think it's when the satellite team played their first game. When they were part of the...
What team were they with?
Me and Omar.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember this.
Because it was the first...
I wasn't there.
It was the first time when we coached... Probably. Omar did, I think.
I know Omar did, but I think I pretty much did, but I just didn't realise.
No, well, that's what coaching is, mate. No, so, yeah, I'd say it was actually the first time I've coached players up that have gone to actually play a game. Do you know what I mean? So that itself was a successful thing. That's a highlight, definitely.
That was a good time, too. That was like... That was 2014, 2015, that.
Fourth...
But not 2013.
It was later than that because I wasn't there.
It was summer, really. Summer 2013.
Sure.
Yeah, because I was flinging someone all over the place, if you remember.
I wasn't playing.
That was the only year that I was eligible for youth.
You showed me a video of you flinging whoever was playing centre all over the place. You've got it.
You were there when...
Was that not...
When we started at South Park.
Was that trick? That one was, I was getting ready for.
You were getting ready to go, you weren't there.
I was playing for Woodham still there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I didn't play in the game.
I'm sure you did.
No, I didn't, I was signed up for Woodham.
Playing in for DC.
No, he's playing for Woodham.
But I'm just saying, like, that one there is... Jack was there, because it was the 2013, because it was literally my first year and only year eligible for that, because I turned 16 at the end that summer.
Oh, bastard. See, I didn't coach that game. Them games, it was...
There's nobody from the Steam there for it.
And that was Matt Logan, wasn't it?
We went down to...
Shirley was there, wasn't it?
No, not
that. No, he was there watching Omar. Mm. The season after is when Shady and
Lee took part. The first game, I think it was only me, and then the second game, it was more local. Because the first game was on the bank holiday weekend, and we got stuck in traffic for about 3 hours on a minibus.
Possibly, yeah.
That was a terrible
game. But yeah, anyway, so there was that. There was that. Fourth.
No, on number four.
I'm on number four now. I would say... I'm thinking. Because I wasn't prepared for it. Do you know how I wasn't prepared for this? Hang on, so fourth.
So you could talk forever.
I can, but I'm thinking. I've got to think though.
This will probably be a good time while Darren's thinking to talk about our merchandise.
Yeah.
Lee's doing a really good job. Constantly making new stuff. As you can see, we've got like we've actually got some different. Shit on each, like not shit on each, but like everyone's got a different style. So as you can see, Lee with his Darlington Steam with a bit of colour. What's it say on there at the bottom?
Established
2013. What a time to be alive. There's the chicken ball. It needs to go into the bin. So Darren's got the white version of the one that I have, which is the black version. I also think Lyman looked better in black. Is that an old one?
Is that the flaw?
I don't want one of the flaws.
Does it make it look skinny? Is that right?
So that's
raised my eyebrow.
That's always a thing.
That's why I should be QB.
Why you got a fucking spider chart going on? Anyway, but basically...
He's mind stopping.
If you'd like to buy some of this merchandise, you can go to the Darlington Steam website, where you can find a link and go on there. If you are a different team or a different company or different business and you have interest in maybe getting some of your own merchandise made... Lee makes it all in this room here, well, usually about 4 o'clock in the morning. and you can get anything. You literally want it, tell him what you want, he'll buy it and sort it out and fix it.
I'd say the best thing about it is it's not going to take months to get there, and there's no minimum order quantity. So if you want one item, just a one-off item, you can have that. If you want bulk, you can do that as well. It really depends on what you want.
And literally, like I say, this is like good quality stuff now. I mean, I've had this for like 2 weeks now, something like that.
This one I've had about 10 months now.
I know, I mean, we're big guys, but this is just a large, like it's perfect. So I'm just kidding. It's a double XL. It's a shit time to be alive. Darren's is a strong XL.
I think it's actually, is it? It's an XL, isn't it?
But either way, the quality is good. The products are good. Fucking hell.
What do I know? It's XL,
isn't it? No, it's a large.
It's a large.
Sheesh. And that's what a large looks like, everybody.
There's a difference between yours and his, though. You got yours at a discount because it was one of the sample ones you had.
Where's
that? The live version. The main thing you'll notice with that one is that it's very soft on the inside. This is another sample.
Just like Jack.
Very soft. ASMR. No, but yeah, that little bit just dropped in there. So yeah, get in touch with Lee. You can go through our Instagram page, through our Facebook page, or go onto the website, go on the contact Lee via email or whatever you need to do, and let's get your orders in. Like we say, it's good quality. Seasons are about to start, teams want to look good.
We've got backpacks coming out soon as well, so
I should have put mine.
Literally
put mine over there. I'll show it, actually.
He's going to get the backpack.
These are good quality. I love my backpack.
Backpack.
Well, now I am going to cargo walk everywhere. It's on my back all the time.
Oh, that's good. Always on your back. That's what you want in your backpack.
He walks to his PT training.
Yes, I do.
Unless I'm driving past.
You want a PT training,
that's just if it's on a morning knackered.
That's it. That's the top quality bags right there. Blocking Darren right out of the video. That's fucking class. So, that little bit's dropped in there. Get in touch. Back onto Darren with his number four.
The first flag win.
Remember.
You what?
Number four is the first flag win.
Flag in win?
Leeds, I believe.
Who was the QB for that team?
I believe it was him.
Him?
Him. That's my name. When
so was you? I thought it was Ben McQueenie. Yeah. I thought Ben McQueenie was in there as well.
He was for the start and then I took over for some reason. I can't remember why.
He got dropped.
Injured his back, probably.
Benched. But
he did suffer with his back. Listen,
I think it was just me in that one.
Yeah. So that was exact. That was my first win as a
football
head coach. Yeah, I was playing as well. Yeah.
You played that game. He's one and
was
only.
The first win, or was the first win that was another win?
No,
the first win you weren't playing, I don't think.
No, I played.
I can never remember.
What position did you play, Darren?
In a slot receiver.
Slot receiver. He was
injury.
He was a hard hitting.
And then linebacker. And linebacker. Yeah, I stopped a beauty pick six so against Sheffield. Dive and catch. I was like, yeah, this
is salmon. Like, hey, we fucking like a salmon.
Then he had to retire.
It felt like I was like a salmon.
It looked.
It probably just like looked like I fell. You know what I mean? But you know, yeah.
And that's why he never plays anymore.
That was back when Dalton didn't have game film.
I don't.
So there's
play.
No history of it at all.
I don't play. There was one I caught over the top on a.
Oh, fuck
no! Hang on. In this play, were you there for that one in Manchester?
Yeah, I'd be.
Caught it over the back, right? And I must have had about 20 yards to run, but I killed about...
The picture of that one is actually on the website.
Well, I killed about a quarter and a half running 20 yards. Seriously, the bear on my back and I just wasn't moving. My legs were. But my body just... It just wasn't moving, honestly. It's so slow. Like, has he got in slow mo? Is he running backwards or what?
I was back when he was in his 30s, so...
Yeah, I was injured there, though. I dislocated for...
Because there's salmon dive.
Yeah,
how was
that?
Yeah,
that's why
he's back injury.
He's making a comeback with the adult flag team, though.
He is, yeah. He's playing this year. Welcome to our backup quarterback, Darren Mitchell.
And he's starting quarterback.
Starting? Nah, no one's going to start with Josh.
Starting
boy.
Centre as well.
He can start centre. We might need him to start centre.
No, right.
Actually, we don't need to start centre now because we've got... you've already announced him. What's his
Jock.
Name?
Yeah.
Jock.
Yeah. Right.
Welcome, Jock.
Number three. The first youth win, which you were there for, the one because
last season,
yeah. The reason why it meant a lot to me is Cole was playing, my youngest,
yeah,
and Harper was playing and scored about 5 touchdowns in that game.
That was against
Chester Romans.
Yeah, Chester Romans.
He absolutely skinned my life.
At home, it was at home.
It was at home, yeah.
Because I know we won a couple that season.
It was a home, and the referee in that game is unfortunately this week has unfortunately passed away. He was refereeing that game, Chris. Yeah.
Yeah.
I swear.
Lovely bloke.
Must have done some of our national final. I looked at his picture on the thing. I was like, I know him.
Yeah, he's a lovely bloke, Chris. Right? Yeah. You know.
Here's a glass to you, sir. All the best. God bless.
God rest his soul. But yeah. That was a great one because it was watching me two boys play. Which was awesome. And watching Harper just put touchdown after touchdown was just unreal.
That was the season that I just randomly became offensive coordinator.
Both still playing though?
Harper not so much. He went to juniors and flamed out. I think he just lost a bit of love for it. Cole's still playing. Cole's a beast.
Machine.
He's
going to be a mint tight end.
Yes, he is. Absolutely. Yeah.
I got thought that was going to be a tight end.
Yeah, you did.
No, and then he went to America for a few weeks and came back. Came back married and full of food.
Yes.
Yeah.
Everything's bigger in Nebraska. Corn for everybody.
Corn steaks. That's all you get.
Tight end and O-line is that like grey area.
Yeah.
And if you pass it one way or the other, that's...
There's no going back. There's no going back.
But yeah, right, number two, last season.
Yeah, it was a good season.
The playoffs, getting to the playoffs, winning NFC to East. That was obviously great, but the fact we lost the playoffs is why it's number two.
Yeah, shit.
So number one was the COVID season because it was my first winning season, and that last game against Gator was just unbelievable. Just it was because I got upset, if you recall, and when all the players just put it on the Instagram, so it's on my Instagram. I don't know if it's on the Steam one, but when everyone got around us, it was funny. Just Northy nearly pulling my head off. And Pacey jumped around in the background. And then just after that, you went and Gatorade bathed me. I was absolutely sober. But that's what it's all about,
isn't
it?
More of a COVID bath than
that. COVID water bath.
Everybody had COVID
after that. Yeah, we just had a time. I was dry within seconds.
You're the only one who didn't get COVID.
I know. I was immune to it then. No, but yeah, that's number one for me.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I agree. That was just, I've got the video on my phone of that whole, like, the players leading up to it. And when that ball got knocked out at the end.
Oh, the sideline erupted.
It was insane. It was absolutely wild. I think I just stood there with my arms open, staring right at Gator's sideline, like, now what? You weren't just, the best anymore.
It was just...
We're here.
It was a turning point, wasn't it? And I know, like, the first game of the next season, they beat us by 2 points.
I'll take ownership.
Which was gutting to lose by something so small. I'd rather get pasted than lose by a small margin.
It would have been better if it was a bit more higher scoring as well, though. It just makes it feel better that it was more of a smaller difference.
Well, yeah.
Rather than not being 14... 16, I think it was.
16, we got them back, though.
Yeah.
And then we beat them at the end of the season.
And that got us our fucking... our season.
Promotion.
It did.
Got us our championship. Well, we won the Div 2 North, and then we all went on to take on Scunthorpe.
That was a good game.
That was probably one of the best games I've played.
It was a great game. It was one hot day, though.
Definitely the best game I played for Steam.
I had pneumonia.
You did?
I had pneumonia.
Yeah, you did. Yeah,
dying during halftime.
We've already spoke about this game a lot. Like, that's not called the Dust Dome. I don't know. Like,
I'm still breathing in dust from that.
Mate, honestly,
I've got asthma now.
Yeah,
fucking asbestos field. Fuck me.
That was their head coach. I mean, their head coach is sound guy. Like, he's like, "Oh, you're not gonna find a better pitch." I said that you should come down. I was green.
Exactly.
Play on tarmac.
So it was like playing an old school Aspro.
Yeah.
It's like playing Horton, where they had the sand Astro.
It was Eastbourne. Eastbourne's old pitch was the sand one. That's what I'm on about. It's the old school where you just take like a couple of layers off your knee if you just touch it.
It's essentially just playing on painted concrete, really.
Pretty much.
That's the real way to play it.
But like I say, overall, it was a great game. You know, it's just unfortunate that we lost. But it is what it is.
It is what it is.
You move on.
I actually like the heat.
The cold got to me.
It got me hyped.
Jordan Mannion enjoyed it.
But the game?
You know, puking up blood.
Ah, yeah. Yeah, we were fucked.
There's a few people who threw up.
Who else went down? Was it P. Diddy went down at all?
The funniest thing was, and me and Jordan, we were talking about it the other day, me and Jordan, and was the medic, who was an outstanding medic, by the way.
Props to the med.
He was awesome. When he came over, and he put his hand in, like, he had a glove on, obviously. Put his hand in the blood that Mannion had puked up. I'm like, oh, that's not clotted, you sound. Like, that's old school stuff. That's class.
At least he knows his stuff, though.
That's the thing. He knew.
He didn't even know it.
Well, that's good.
He knew what he was checking for straight away, but it was just like, it's one of those moments where it's like, Brit ball all over, where you're just like, yeah, it makes sense.
Comes over, yeah.
Makes it up, just one clump.
blood drip out, he's like, okay? Yeah, that's fine, you'd be okay, carry on planting.
It's when he licked his fingers on the way off, was really like, he didn't bother.
What can we say? Finger looking good.
I'd like to say one thing about your top five things.
Yes.
I'm involved some way or another in every single one of them.
There you go, you're welcome.
Oh, fuck, I know. And after this, you can sign up onto Lee's OnlyFans, in which you'll see what Darren does to him.
It's all about the feet.
No, that's wiki feet.
Wiki, wait, the what?
There's a where you can rate people's feet on there. Literally, it's just a bunch of tons of people, and it's just rating
feet. Zero feet are disgusting.
It's weird as hell. To be fair, there's one person there who is higher than the actual rating, so it's out of five. They've got a 6 somehow.
What's the point of having ratings if you're going to go over them? I hate when people go, oh, give it 10%, or oh, give it 100%, and they go, I'm going to give it 110%.
You can't.
Just don't.
100% is no such thing as
just give us 100%, that's fine. That's all we need.
So how can you do 100% for both?
What?
When you're a head coach and chairman.
This
is the problem. I tried to give 100% for both. Unfortunately, I couldn't. And hit burnout.
That's 200%. But I know a song that it does make 200%.
No, but you can give 100% to a role. To it. Shut up, man. Who fought him? I know it's his house.
It's his house. His setup. We'd just be sat on the phone talking to each other if we were late.
That's a good 2 hours.
It's been a long 10 years.
Right, between you then, so you've asked. Right, so you've asked me my top five. What would yours between you, as far as Steam's concerned, your own personal ones?
It just goes all the way from Steam Attack.
Trying to leave and not being able to. The last 3 years, I've been trying to leave the Darren Steam. Just do not play anymore. Just when I thought I was out, they pull me back in.
Not allowed.
No,
it's because you got to pay the leaving fee.
Yeah, that's what it is. I don't pay taxes.
Hello,
I was actually talking about this last night.
Is that the HMRC?
Yeah. Do you give rewards for?
Oh no, yeah.
So for me, the biggest like shake coming to the Darren's thing was that I've never ever paid subs in my entire career.
I know, that's why you're on the debt list.
That's why he's going back.
I'm on the debt list. But prior to that,
that's one thing that's happening long term, is sorting out that debtors list.
I played on a lot of teams and I've never once had to pay. And then I had to come to Darren's team, and by the way, Darren's team don't give you a bad deal at all. But that's the hard part, is now I have to pay.
You don't pay.
Instead of getting paid, I'm paying.
It's free.
It's free if you just ignore it.
I'm a fine as well, shit. I owe you guys a lot of money, I suppose.
Yes, you do, yeah.
But I've given a lot, though.
He's got the 10 years of receipts ready.
So I suppose the highlight for me was being a captain for the Alphas game. That was my highlight. And that game itself, like, well, even with the loss, that game reminded me of what it was like to play football properly.
So
not playing against, like, teams on blowouts. But, like, actually playing football and wanting to fucking win. The other games, I didn't...
Battle, wasn't it?
It was how it used to be.
So where would that game rank in your all-time games?
20.
It's in the top five.
Turn his mic off.
It's in the top five. Yeah.
You can't hear me. I've talked too quietly anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, sorry. Top five. I would say... I had some good games in the GFL. Like some really like... It meant a lot to us because it hit to a point that when I got there, they were already like on a downward trend,
mm-hmm.
And they were trying to stay out of relegation. And there was a lot of games where we like fought tooth and nail just to stay up.
Mm-hmm.
So there's like one or two games that are in the top three there. I suppose you're going to the Woodham games, but I would say probably number five.
Okay.
I couldn't think of other games to go in without like spending like half an hour here thinking about them all. But obviously, a lot of my national finals kind of go into it. Played against the Americans that would like, I can't remember what the fucking league is called now. Like the same league as Fulton used to play. What's it called? American High School.
Oh, it was,
Military. No, I can't remember. It's fucking Dodds League.
That's the one.
We had some good games in Dodds League where we're like, a highlight would be we went up against Menwith Hill. It was their homecoming game. And we fucking went to their place and we fucking annihilated them. Annihilate. They didn't know what to fucking do. These little English teams just came in and destroyed them. Next year, we had to partner. Well, I left, but they partnered up with them and like had the Woodham Mustangs or whatever it was going to be.
I can remember the Woodham game against Menwith at
Blackwell.
At Blackwell, yeah.
You were both there.
Before the stands were there. Well, like, we brought all of our youth team over.
That was a wild game.
It was brilliant.
That was honestly. Slim.
And I was forward thinking then, saying, right, these are going to come great soon. I'm going to end up with half this squad. Do you know what I mean?
They were like the high. They were like the younger games are better. I've preached this a lot on this. I think anyone who's playing youth football, it's so much better than adult football because it just means so much more.
Because I think you can enjoy it more.
Exactly. There's no pressure. You know, you're literally just playing because you enjoy it, and you can do loads of wild shit, and you get that real feel of what it's like. And then you put the dedication in, and you end up. There's something at the end of it. There's that opportunity to go somewhere else.
Yeah.
A lot of these guys playing adult football. What are you doing?
Now, the problem I find with adult football is it's the shit talking about other teams.
Yeah.
I can't stand it, and I've always tried to, like, get that through with the steam. What?
You're literally unsportsmanlike.
Every single
podcast. Unsportsmanlike. Yeah, yeah.
No, but what I'm saying is, no, it's like they spend more time talking about other teams. And the way I've always viewed it is, if you spend that much talking about other teams all the time, you're taking the attention off yourself.
Yeah.
So no wonder you don't improve, and no wonder the standard shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. The standard of British football is shit.
And this is what I'm trying to change just with our team. You know what I mean? Or our club, sorry. You know what I mean? I don't have time for all that crap. I've heard other teams that are in like chat groups talking shit about other teams. It's like, grow up.
Yeah, you're all shit anyway.
It just boils my piss. That's all. Because I try and have a good relationship with all the other teams because I don't see a reason why not. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, when the you know, when that first whistle goes, yeah, you know, I want to rip your face off.
Yeah.
That's just, you know. But when the final whistle goes, all said and done.
Still want to rip your face off. But we can check.
I'll just be nice about it.
So with that being said, then I know this might be a tough topic, and you might tell me to fuck off. But what's your most? What's the, in your opinion, either the worst team in Baffa, or the team you don't like in Baffa,
or both,
or both.
Worst team in Baffa.
I mean, your in your opinion, like whether it's just local, because I know there's like some shit teams down south as well, but we obviously don't really know a lot about them.
No, so you, just from what I know.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you just throw some shade if you want to.
No.
What?
London Olympians.
No, the...
insert dance for generation games.
Yeah. Worst team, I would say, and Dan Hook's not going to like me for this, but South Lincolnshire Lightning, I would say. There's a few that are close. Like the worst performing team, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Where
their standards are in their development, because that's, they've gone backwards, they've gone to associate. Yes, they have.
Okay.
Breaking news.
Well, they have.
Just talk to you.
officially been and what there. Was the other one? The one I don't like.
What team don't you like? Like when you stare over at them, you look at me and you go, I just want to rip your face off, you cunts. Or you look at me and you go, what a worthless waste of my time.
No, it's not a worthless waste of my time. The team I don't like, but I do like at the same time are the Vikings, because I haven't beaten them yet.
Yeah.
Just for that reason.
We played well against them.
We played very well against them, but I haven't beat them yet.
Hey, I
like them. I get on with all of them. But the thing is, right, I want to beat them.
True.
I remember a sack which I didn't.
That's the only reason.
Hmm? I jumped in on defense for one or two plays and sacked a QB.
You did?
On the first game, I think it was.
I went and then pancaked one of the top tackles. Just flew under the floor. Got a picture of it. I got actually got four pictures of me going up,
selfie,
getting right underneath him, watching him go, oh shit, his feet are off the ground, and then the next player watching him on the floor and me walking all over him.
They're in the bathroom, one of them.
You are? You are?
They're in the bathroom in photos, aren't they?
Yes.
That's why he has a camera in his hand.
Yeah, it
that's
is.
There's a couch in the background.
Couch yeah.
On the table.
Sick. So what about yours? What's your best moment? Am I in mind now the interviewer?
He does this, by the way. I knew he would do this because we've talked about this like years ago. He went to an interview once and interviewed the interviewer for a job.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. Just sit here and get fucking roasted. We're gonna.
It's clever. I'm just clever.
Still a lot of time left. I'm gonna rip you to shreds.
Go for it. I don't give a shit. Do it.
there's a few first win with the steam. Which was a flag game, obviously.
You played quarterback?
Yeah, me playing back quarterback.
I was playing.
So. I really enjoyed the time when I played juniors. I didn't play. So the weird thing about it, I didn't play juniors after I turned 16 until I was in uni.
Mm.
So I'm of the age of where I skirted into the juniors on my first year of uni, so I played 11v11, then I dropped to 7 on 9s, I can't remember which it was on the day.
9s.
And I was playing for the Vikings, and that was just insane. It's just fun, it's like so much easier.
Which was the first time you were playing alongside the likes of Jordan McCabe.
Jordan McCabe.
He was there. Northy was there, but he wasn't there.
No?
No. Had...
Richie Howe was there.
Richie, yeah.
Big up Richie Howe.
Josh Penny.
Big up Josh Penny. Wooden Boys.
And there was another one, who was it?
There's one from... There's
there was two, a linebacker.
Two from Steam, two
from where?
Woodham.
But there's what? Also two from Steam as well.
Yeah, there was Jamie Buckingham.
Jamie Buckingham and was it?
Killian.
There might have been three then.
No, it was different.
I remember another person as well.
Zach Hornby.
Yeah, that's Zach, yeah.
What I remember from Killian was a play, I think it was on the 1 yard line, and it was a gap had opened for their running back to come through, and just Killian just met, bang, it was just stopped him dead, it was outstanding. Like, what a play, I was so proud, I was doing the chains on Nottingham's side, I was just beaming with pride over that, it was just awesome, I was like, get up.
You're supposed to be fucking impartial.
Nah, I couldn't be.
It's a good little dig. If you're
not when it's youth and junior development, you're proud of what they're doing. Do you know what I mean?
If you're a Wakefield,
you've been with it.
Wakefield fan, you would have remembered that from the suspension letter. Supposed to be fucking impartial. Because you're fucking meant to be.
Shut up.
I didn't say it though.
I'm not dealing with more emails over there.
I apologise for that. Second, and I got cleared.
Jack, it's fine.
I apologised and got cleared. I apologised on the field to the referee.
I was going
to
find him doing.
Oh, don't start with Paffer. Paffer couldn't have gained
ban, I was going to get.
How much?
Paffer couldn't have gained ban, I was going to get.
Do you know what it is? Because it's after it's Baffer's fucking Christmas party. We talk about this every episode. Baffer, your Christmas party better be fucking good, and we want to invite.
But anyway, we've got clear.
We'll host the event for you.
Live podcast, talk and we'll host it, and we'll just ruin it.
We'll bring Kev.
So how much did you spend on this Christmas party this year? About 340.
Yeah. About 10 Darlington Steam suspensions.
How many suspensions do we need to cover the excess that we spent this year?
Not dealing with suspensions again.
If I get suspended again, will it be still two games? These are a lot of questions I have.
So here's the thing. Right.
That's a genuine question.
Hang on. All our suspensions, which has been four. Right.
Unsportsmanlike conduct.
Hang on.
Hence the name.
All from Aycliff. You. Portsworth. McCabe.
I remember, you know what, I remember McCabe's as well, because he had no reason to do what he did. He just did it because he could.
He said to me, sorry, I don't know why I did that.
I literally walked behind him and I watched him start, and I was like, you fucking idiot, I'm going to have to go centre now. I literally started peeling my tape on, like, fucking, here we go, let's go again.
Oh, I've got to love McCabe.
It'd be great if he came back, but I suppose that's a, we'll have to sit, wait and see.
Life moves on, doesn't it?
Yeah, down south.
Caesars, you've got a good player. You've probably got one of the best
Look
guards.
After him. You all right?
Yeah. Let's go. Move on.
He's thinking of all the flags he gets.
Yeah, literally, I guess. Highlights. If I don't get flags like four times a game,
like
then
a pride
it's
rally, the more flags that are flying with you.
What's your best... What's the flag that you think was the best?
I have two. So, in the UK... it was a thrown a punch Newcastle Vikings flag.
You're protecting your quarterback,
because it is like I say this every time I talk about it, and every time I spoke about it on this podcast as well. I'm just a big believer that we are playing amateur football in this country, because that's what Baffa allows us to do. And I just watched a man who I grew up with, who has like a fucking school of kids at home. I just watched him get absolutely obliterated by some cunt in a black uniform. So I got obliterated as well on that return. I looked up, saw them all cheering, and thought, well, fuck this shit. Jumped over him, left him on the floor, just started throwing punches. And Tony Speeman, I love you, man, but you're fucking killing me. He pulled me over under the floor and then made me immobile.
Yeah, but he pulled you out of the way so Alex Crossley can jump in.
Yeah, Alex Crossley came
out of nowhere. Letting everybody have a turn.
He absolutely laid him out as well. It was absolutely insane. But that was a good one there. The second best one was when I was in Germany, and I just started like learning German properly. And then I heard them call a holding call, and I heard my number get called out, and I was like, oh shit, that's me. And I turned around to the side and I went, I didn't hold. I don't hold. I did hold. When I look back on the game film later on, when we did film sessions, there was me clearly holding.
Choke slamming.
Trying to hold on for dear life.
Yes. I'm not holding. This is the one I hold.
Yeah, so like hearing my number get called out in German, I was like, oh, 64. Oh, that's me. Oh, wait, and I turned around to someone and went, what was that call for? They went, oh, holding. I was like, ah, I wasn't holding. Yeah. Matt Storium. Story. Well,
that's what happened.
Let's move on.
I've been close to being ejected in a couple of games. I've been flagged for sideline infraction, I don't know how many times. I nearly jumped all over the referee's back. I should have been ejected at Scunthorpe.
If I was a referee, I'd probably ejected.
Yeah, I should have been ejected at Scunthorpe. I'm so very surprised he just threw a flag on 50
yards. Because he was like dehydrated and he didn't know what he was doing.
No, I was fuming.
He was just fucking gone.
I was fuming.
The rest.
Were you fuming at the referees? I didn't notice.
You should have been. And then. Yeah, but well, respect no help, you know that. And then there was one in flag. Can you remember Halifax?
I hate flag.
Everything that happens.
Right. Flag, I don't hate flag.
I hate flag in terms of the self-refereeing.
Self-refereeing is crap. Yeah. But at any level. But he said to me, because I said he's talking shit, and then he went, if you don't shut up, I'll eject you. I went, are you going to move me? Like,
fuck off.
I remember that.
Remember it?
You dickhead.
Which he said, will you get ejected? I went, you've said, but what are you going to do?
You should have been literally banned from the sport.
Yeah, I know, but I wasn't. He didn't even eject me.
You should have got a whole year ban.
It was ages ago.
And
he
ejected two people.
You what?
And now, he ejected two people.
It was a referee in football. I was awful referee.
You're a great player, but you're just an asshole. Well.
Yeah. So I've refereed a game where I pulled the captains in. My old man told me to do this. So I pulled the captains in and said, look, I said, if I end up with players flying up to me and kicking off, I'll just send them off. I'm not messing around. They swear at me once, they're done. Right? Straight away it happened. See you later. You know what, you want one?
You're just like...
No, I just sent the players. I said, I'll hand out cards all day. It doesn't bother me. Do you know what I mean? And then there was one where there was a free kick at the edge of the box. So that team come flying up to me. It was a clear free kick. Come flying up to me. Only the keeper stayed. They came flying up to me and I had the whistle in my mouth. And I just blew the whistle and they just took the free kick whilst all them were stood there. And I went, I warned you. But I warned them, though.
I'd do that just because I'd just laugh at them.
But I did it with a smile on my face. I was happy.
You know what? I think you're right. I mean, I was going to say about the first
now, person. Now, that's why I take after my old man, too.
First person to get ejected as a chairman.
No, I won't.
No, you can't be, because I think it's already happened.
I'll be chilled, mate.
2012 DC presidents. If they didn't, every player didn't get ejected, every coach got ejected, the whole team. That was like back in like Johnson years, that. I love how that's DC's like literally their best time of their lives.
Just everybody getting ejected.
But I reckon you will get ejected this year for some. You? Yeah.
Nah, I won't.
Two fucking rights.
Nah, I won't.
As a fan, yeah. Can you please remove this guy off the field?
My
fucking club, mate. I'm not fucking going anywhere.
No. He's just here. He lives here.
Yeah.
That's my own. No.
Just have a bitch.
I'm chilled now. Chilled.
Okay. Chilled. And then literally as soon as this video goes off, what did I fucking tell you?
I don't have a Jekyll and Hyde personality much. Neither do I.
This guy.
Anyway.
Fuck it. Clicks.
You get it.
This guy's a dickhead.
Anyway, how do you think the team's going to get on this season?
Mid-table. Yes.
We and Jack have always said, I've said third, Jack said fourth.
I think third or fourth is about right.
So,
because we're not going in this. Hang on, we're not going in this season just to take part.
What are we here to do?
Quite.
What are we here to do? No, you just take part.
Either win, baby.
We're here to take over.
So, what position are you going to be then?
Huh?
Are you going to come in the league if you're here to win?
Well, yeah, I want to be first. Aim for first.
I had a very long phone call last night with our new head coach.
Yes.
And in that phone call, with acquisitions that have been made along with the head coach, with people moving up from junior level, and with a possibility of players who may return this season.
Yeah.
There's potential, in my opinion, where we could fight for the second spot.
Well, the first game will be a testament to that in the morning. Oh, the Rams is going to be a baptism of fire, but it's going to tell us where we are.
This is always what's got me, yeah. They're no different than a Div 2 team. They're just very... Look at it this way,
they're
yeah.
They're a good team.
They're a good team. Like, no one's like taking it away from them. But it's just football. Like, we literally got promoted this year, but last year we were a Div 2 team, and this year we're a Div 1 team. Mm-hmm. Have we just grew overnight and became amazing?
Yeah, but that depends who you talk to. Some people believe we shouldn't be there.
Some people might be wrong, though, mightn't they?
I agree.
Say, on the technicalities, and if you're looking at Baffa's specific, if you follow the rules that essentially set out, we shouldn't be.
Yeah.
But, because they're realigning stuff, they needed to promote somebody, and
would we have been
conference winners.
Would we have been put in Div 1 if we're not worthy of it?
With Baffa, yes.
Well, I don't think we would have been.
As you said, baptism of fire.
That's why the thing is, so there's two divisions that actually got two promotions in.
Yes.
One was Premiership North,
mm-hmm.
and the other one was Div 1 North.
Mm-hmm.
And that was us and
Scunthorpe.
And I can't remember who was the Premiership ones, but it's because of how the division's been realigned. Yes. That's why we got the promotion, because we won our conference and they needed the extra team from that side.
Yeah, and because of the record as well.
Yeah. We're the best of the rest, essentially. Mm-hmm. So they needed to get the numbers up so they can have the same amount of numbers.
Did Staffordshire go up? I don't think they did it?
No.
Didn't they drop out of their playoff game?
Yeah, they did.
They don't deserve shit.
Well, lucky John.
No, they didn't, because...
runs them. Sorry, John.
The winner of the team that they dropped out against would have went up instead of them.
Yeah.
Scotland's just
doing what they want to do.
Where did Dumfries go?
Right.
Well,
they've just gone.
They're on the west coast. It's been a long time.
No, but
so now they're on island.
No, but we played against them, what, two or three seasons ago?
Are they called the Dumfries Kings or something?
Dumfries Hunters. Dunfermline Kings.
All right. Yeah, I don't know where they've gone.
Associate.
I wonder if they've merged with someone.
Probably.
Anyway.
Don't know.
Hands up if you give a fuck, and we'll move on.
It just popped in my head, that's all.
Sorry.
Yeah, realistically, you're thinking third, fourth, really?
Yeah.
Okay. In terms of this season, how do you think it's going to progress the team as a whole? Do you feel like it's going to be more of a restructuring and bedding year more than anything, or is it going to be like... trial by fire.
That was a long sigh.
I don't know, to be honest.
It's just because there's coaching changes, there's back end changes and everything. There's a lot of changes going on. I know you said you don't know, but it's just like, what are your feelings, just like from within the club as a whole, and
very positive.
Yeah.
Because. It takes time to get there with any organisation, but I feel like we're getting the right people in the right places now. Do you know what I mean? And I think that's what's going to elevate us more than what we've ever had. We've been able to concentrate on the run of the club off the field. Like I say, I can put 100% into it. So I've got a head coach taking care of the other thing now, whereas before, when you're doing both, it's exhausting, yeah. It's just exhausting. But the thing is, I don't advise anyone to do that, but you do it because you love it. That's why I did it. Do you know what I mean?
You've been doing it
a long time. Regret it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's just, it was time. I knew, I've spoken to yourselves individually, that I knew after the Alphas game that I needed to happen. What did I do at the end of the game?
To be fair, he was going to... You were going to play out this year.
I was.
Depending on the situation, but the situation has changed. And
yeah, because I didn't...
Needed to.
Yeah.
So, I think sooner rather than later it's probably better, because you were already in that mindset.
It's
for the best that you've done it earlier, and it's progressed to insane amounts already.
Well, yeah, I mean, one thing that's remained consistent since day one is the best interest of the club's always been at the forefront.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So, like, I remember the team talk about sacrifices. That I did this before, that I've sacrificed a lot for this club, and players have sacrificed a lot for us.
Too much.
What players?
Sacrificed too much.
Me?
Yeah, 100%. I said that the awards night, and I stand by it today. I think people in the sport, more specifically you, if you think about it now, you're like 41, 42.
42, yeah.
42-year-old, and the club's been on for 10 years. We spoke the other day, and I hope you don't mind me saying this, but I said to you, when did you last take a family holiday? Since I've known you in 10 years, you and your kids have never been abroad on a family holiday.
No.
You watch your kids grow up on the side of a field
mm-hmm.
to watch this club progress. And now, sometimes I just don't feel like the appreciation's there from players. I don't think people understand the actual sacrifice that's gone into it. It's always just like, oh, well, we can go play football here. But like, this guy's like literally giving up 10 years of his life, watch his kids. To be fair, I've known Colin Harper since they were fucking toddlers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, he's known us since we were kids.
This is it, yeah. And now it's like, I was literally saying this how I like put it. I'm about to come to the age that you were when we first met.
Yeah.
That's scary. And I mean, I've said on a personal note for me, I don't want to be in that position where when I have a family, that I'm going to spend all day around the field like you did.
No.
And that's nothing that I don't think you did the right or wrong thing or whatever. It's just you've sacrificed some of that. I wouldn't sacrifice that, but mm-hmm. you did, but because you loved it. Mm-hmm. So if you're ever fucking thinking to yourself, oh, should I stay at the dance team? Should I come to the dance team? Yeah, you fucking should, because people actually put the effort in to make the club happen. Where a lot of clubs just fucking turn up and just do their shit, don't they? And just play about and crack on. I'm not going to name teams, but you come to here, you've got people who actually give a fuck. So
you do want to name a team, really, don't you?
I could name about fucking 10, but the serious part's over now.
So that's going to be a rally.
2007 was when I saw them.
2007?
Australia, yeah.
Australia, 2007. Australia. 2000, that's almost like 20 years ago.
Before the recession.
It was definitely, it's awesome.
Should have just went.
But do you not like sit and think like shit?
There's a number of reasons for it, though. Do you know what I mean? It's not just the football. The football's a big part of it.
You missed Mike Stagg doing Benidorm.
I know, dude.
What a wild one, that. I could have used you in the fight.
Yeah.
No, I just think, like, you just give a lot. So I
appreciate that.
Take this time as a GM, whatever, to, yes, enjoy the football, enjoy everything else, but at the same time, enjoy some family time.
Oh, absolutely.
Even though your kids have now grown up and at that stage where they don't care about you.
Thanks.
Cole Harper.
Yeah.
Well, that's me done now. It's been nice doing the podcast for you, lads.
There we go.
On that note. Jersey off.
Oh, he's taking it back off you.
Yeah. Whether that's what Sunderland Uni do, don't they?
Yeah.
Fucking 50 quid for a new jersey, but by the way, give me a back.
They still do that, though.
They fucking right.
They probably still do.
Oh, you know.
Because they work
for Wilden. That's what it was last night.
They work for Baffa.
Yeah, man.
It's a part of the Christmas party.
They're making fingerless glove mandatory for the uni teams.
I want palmless gloves.
That's what they're doing next. So they're making normal full gloves. They're keeping the fingertips and they're selling them next year.
Yeah, that's it. Just the like long thimbles.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Yeah, did I actually tell you about the summons, what they did for the jerseys?
Well, I listened to it on the podcast when you were about it.
I don't know why anybody took it off, because people actually did. I'm pretty sure they just kept the jersey.
You know why? It's because university students get given so much money at the start of a school year, mm-hmm. and they just fucking waste on whatever they want, and they think, oh yeah, I'll pay for a jersey that I never get to keep.
Cause
fucking fool. It's
only behind the barn shooting union.
A ton of money that gets shot.
Yeah, I know.
It's insane. But yeah, no, it was a really strange situation. Is that's why I didn't do it. It's because the university wouldn't pay for new jerseys because we called the Sunderland Spartans.
Mm.
And they wanted to be called under the university, which was like the Tigers or something like that. I can't remember.
Sunderland Tigers sounds underneath.
Now I was talking
more unified. That's what it was. And
so there's the thing. Team names, right? No, I was talking to Lee Howard. And he wants to do...
He's already told me about this exact same podcast. Thing, you know.
No, going through the team names of the worst, the worst team names.
We also
why.
Want to do one for the jerseys and
yeah.
stuff like that.
We already started doing a bit of a jersey one last time.
So what do you think is the best one?
What, jersey or team
yeah,
name?
Yeah, best jersey in UK. Or best, like, kit. I've got two favourites. And they're not ours.
Yeah, no. I don't mind ours, but ours look very. It looks almost like sporty.
I want to renew. We're not playing a sport, are we?
Next year.
I want to renew them.
Yeah. And an away kit.
Yeah.
I've talked a bit about it before as well with you.
Yes.
I will be for that.
I think it's.
But you want a kit though.
Yeah.
My favorite, I think it was Oxford Saints. The purple kit, I think.
All right.
It was still quite wild. Like purple and gold, the sort of thing.
Okay.
I like purple.
Do you think?
It's just a nice color. Yeah. Like the royal purple sort of thing, like deep purple, not just like.
Yeah.
It's like a very deep purple, like the
Well, like a bit royalty like purposes. Would you say it's a bit like Durham Saints?
Maybe Durham Saints, I can't remember.
Durham Saints wear a lot of purple.
My two favourites is the Scunthorpe Alpha's white top and blue bottoms. It's nice.
It is.
And
but you could have chosen blue.
I think it's Northants Knights. I like their uniform as well.
Maybe I'm just like, I'm boring, but I kind of like London Blitz all white. I love all white. I think it's like one of the best uniforms to have. It's like white Dallas Cowboys. I love Dallas Cowboys. The fact that right. they wear away jerseys for home games
I
and stuff.
Our away jerseys though should try to stand out some more.
Like pink.
I was talking about Jack. We should have a charity jersey, charity kit, like what we do once
October.
A year, which is like pink for breast cancer awareness or something like that. Just have it there, so like we could do it every year. We have that this kit to raise money for charity for a game.
So if we played a game in that kit, doesn't have to be in October. It could be any
Season game.
Season game. So if we're charging people entry.
Yeah, all of it.
All proceeds go to charity.
All profits go to
because we're a charitable organization.
We're good people, that's why.
So these jerseys behind us would have to be away kits. There's a rule I'm pretty sure that says you have to have one white or a light uniform.
It's a weird rule, and I don't think it's very enforced tons, or it's like enforced at all really. So the rule is away kits must be white.
Is this the asking the permission thing?
Unless you ask permission of the home team or Baffa or Baffa references. I don't know if it's necessarily referees or if it's Baffa. I think it's Baffa. If you can use an alternative contrasting colour to the home team.
So we actually had something like this. I can't remember who we were playing. It was at Woodham Times. And our jerseys were extremely similar to London Warriors.
Right.
London Warriors had like a bluey black. And in our first year, we had a bluey black. Or bluey silver. And I can't remember what the thing was. I think they had two kits. Can't remember what the crack was. Actually, I think that was the year we got new kits. We went and got our like silver kits like this. We said, well, we can either turn our jerseys inside out or we can ask them if they'll wear a different jersey. I don't think they were going to. So we ended up just buying brand new silver jerseys and rocking up with something completely different. And they were like, fair play.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
To be fair, I'd say most teams in the UK are generally all right with switching kits if they need to. Mm-hmm. Don't think they mind really that much. Even if you aren't playing in your home kit and if the other team only has one. But
I mean, ours is a generic away jersey. Everyone always says it's like silver or white or actually, they say grey. How many arguments have I had with the referee?
I've had them call us white. I've had them call us grey.
Grey is the worst one.
I think it's more whitey when you first buy it and it just becomes a bit more grey.
It's silver.
Unless it's Liam Wood's top. And it's like black and brown. Have you seen the stuff?
It's fucking filthy.
Minged.
It's not been cleaned in like 3 years.
He had it at practice the other day. Yeah, he's so got the.
It's been left in.
He's got the paint. He's got the pitch markings and the dust from the Alphas game.
Fucking
it
hell.
Hasn't been out of his boots since the Alphas game.
So much dust.
Mate, honestly.
There's not enough Hoovers in the world to fucking clean that field up.
He's burning.
Henry died trying to sort it out.
Yeah.
If you go into the
Alpha's, he had a smirk on his face on the Hoover. The Alpha's pretty stuck. It was so sad.
If you go to the Alpha's changing room, there's just like a Henry Hoover hanging itself from the fucking showers.
Yeah.
Cold shower on, it's just dangling. Oh well, move on. Before we get fucking banned.
We don't advocate suicide, brother.
No, definitely not.
Why did you have to say that? I feel that's like, fair enough, we don't, but I just didn't know there would be clarification there.
You do. Generally, it's weird. The internet.
Yeah, you have to.
You
do. Seriously, honestly.
You're fucking with me.
Read the speech.
If someone...
Oh, fucking hell, why did you have to do that? And then you pulled a face to the camera. We're good, we're done.
Anyway.
This is the last episode you'll ever see.
Like I said, I think we should have a charity kit, but have like maybe move this to away kit so that we have an away kit still ready to go and have a new home kit and then change it all the time for the away kit if you want to.
What home colour would you have?
Something completely different just to mess up people.
If it wasn't for the Vikings, we'd have all black.
I'd go red.
Or just full stealth black.
Like red and then black stripe there. No, white, a red stripe there, and
just
then
full stealth black.
Oh, just go like white.
Blackout numbers
black,
and everything.
Black. Yeah.
No. Referee's like, holding on the offense, night. And that's it.
Yeah, but look like DC's kits, and DC's kits will just look like a practice kit.
DC, I actually rate DC's.
I didn't mind them because they don't. Okay, they're like practice kits, but they just have a little bit extra. I'd say, like, they don't do anything extra. Just
I like.
Is it just me, or do they feel like mesh slick?
Is it the EP Sports ones?
Like, yeah, weirdly slick. Like
Sports, it's all the fucking lube out. They use in the toilet. Okay. It's just turned 9:10. This was supposed to happen at some point.
I've just got an email.
You got two games of suspension.
That would be a fucking treat, I won't lie.
Behave yourself.
You could spend the suspension at any other game.
Yeah.
Or if you could, probably.
What?
Spend the suspension at any other game.
You know what? Those three games we've got in a row. We'll find out then.
We won't.
Oh, God. Yeah, no, it's interesting, really. I think there's a lot of things that we could do with the kit which makes it look class. I think if we're redoing it, we should try to get some more, like, 3D-ness into it. So, like, not just printed onto it, so it's like these are actually, like, part of the jersey, so they're raised off.
See, I know we've got the logo there, but I'd like Steam across here. I've always wanted that across there.
Yeah.
You guys make me sick.
You shut up. Let us talk.
So sick. I feel ill. It's more chicken.
I think having black fully, possibly if you want to include the red or white and white piping or red piping with white piping around the letters.
Someone fucking baking a cake.
Speaking of baking a cake, right? No, hang on. So it was Cole's birthday on Friday.
Oh, fuck
her. No, so we were in Tesco's trying to find a cake for him. So we looked at a chocolate one, then we looked at a unicorn one, and sat near because we just wanted to take the piss and get him a frozen one. Right? I thought we wanted to need the defrosting, by the way. And then my stepdad was there, and he went, just give him these. And it was just eggs and flour in that. It was one of those two things came out my mouth. Was the first one was, there was a decision made here.
Yeah.
Where they just, I'm going to bake a cake, looked at the cakes, went, no, fuck it, I'm just going to buy one, right? Or I thought it was an IKEA, where I'm going to have to make my own. Do you know what I mean?
To be fair, I love just going through the stores and just thinking what decisions people made by just putting stuff randomly anyway.
It's class, isn't it?
Yeah, like, there's always some funny stuff around, like, where the nappies are, or where, like, the shampoo and stuff is, because you always see something random there.
The
like
beer aisle's the best.
Like condoms.
No, the beer aisle's the best.
Oh, yeah. You see, like, the...
I've seen condoms next to the nappies.
Yeah. Fucking decisions were made. Bit late.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, it's one of those, isn't it? Yeah.
Fucking hell. Go on, you bought your beer aisle.
No, you always see, like, there's a box missing from the bud, and then there's always something there.
Yeah.
Where a guy just went, fuck it.
I'll go for a cheap, cheeky water beer. That's what it usually is. I did the exact same thing the other day. I literally picked up a crate of beer, put it into my basket, walked off somewhere else, told Emily, said, I'll be back in 2 minutes. Went back down to the beer aisle with my beer, looked for another one, thought, well, that's the same price.
What did you leave then?
I left both of them, decided not to drink at all. I just went, I'll have some rum when I get home. So I went home and had rum instead. They're adult decisions right there.
Whenever I've seen anything in the beer aisle left, it's always been something healthy.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Like seltzers or something like that.
I've seen the flavoured water in there. I've seen a cucumber.
That's a conversation. Oh, okay. That's a conversation for another podcast, that one.
Fuck's sake.
Yeah, no, it's just the weirdest thing. Happens, I don't know why, but it's...
I want to know more about the cucumber.
I don't.
In the beer aisle.
With cucumber and fucking flavoured water, what were they doing?
It'd be more funny if it was in the wine aisle.
Anyway, moving on swiftly.
I knew this was going to be like this.
Who's going to win Brit Ball as a whole? Everything.
Everyone's a winner. Football's
what team,
a winner.
What team? Well, the people who are going to win is Baffer itself, but next down from that.
No, no, I think
so. What do you mean, Brit Balls or Hall? Who's going to win the Prem?
Do all three of them if you want, or just do it.
There's no Div 2, Div 1, Div
it's up to you.
Premier.
I need to see the alignments. I would say Manchester for Prem.
What?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Titans again.
Div 1. Tate Hamley.
This actually might be a good time, actually, to talk a bit about what you actually do in the background when you're not doing that on Steam, Darren.
No, there's a few things, really. There's what, for a living?
Yeah.
PT, got my own business.
You're a PT. For those of at home who are of the same size as me and Lee, what does PT stand for?
Part-timer, no. Personal trainer, yeah.
So how long have you been doing personal training for, Darren?
Since 2017, I think. Yeah. Maybe 2016, I don't know.
I was one of Darren's first success stories.
You sure were?
And then I put all my weight back on once I got married, so...
Highly educated, you didn't know.
But Darren runs a very good PT business, really helping a lot of people, helped myself and my wife on the way lead up to our wedding, but also helping me before as well. And I know there's a lot of other people who are not related to the Darren Steen community or any football community who you've actually supported in the past. Yeah, hell of a PT.
It's a rewarding job.
It's got clients from different sports backgrounds as well, golf.
Yeah, I do a lot of sports specific stuff as well, yeah. So there's golf, there's boxing, there's MMA, rugby, American football, soccer. Yeah, is that it?
You do like private stuff as well, don't you? Like one-on-one training.
Yeah, that's what all that is.
Sports as well.
Yeah. So there's weight loss stuff and muscle mass building, and there's even
a lot of recovery as well, wasn't there?
Yeah, so it's more rehabilitation stuff. So what the process normally is you get, obviously the injury happens, you get the operation, if the operation's needed, then it's physio. Once the physio have done their bit, it's then time for the PT to take over and rehabilitate it and strengthen that area back up. But yeah, it's we have a lot of injury rehabilitation. There's a lot of it now.
Have you got many openings? If anyone was interested in maybe coming down and working
absolutely
on it? Yeah. Best way to get in touch with through Darren's Steen website, maybe, is, or
have you got
a card that we can pop under the screen right about now?
I can show someone on the screen.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, so if you're interested and you want to maybe get that, you know, that Christmas weight off, or maybe you just want to work out a bit more, maybe need a little bit more motivation, a bit of a plan, this guy right here can help you. So have a look on the link that we're going to post up. Get in touch with Darren and he'll help you with as much as he can.
I'd say we could just book a taster session just to get people used to it, because that's the thing. It's normally the
you also do group sessions as well. So if there's more than one, and maybe there's two or three of you, and you fancy just getting out together and actually having a plan, maybe see who can lift the most. This guy over here will help you out, and then make you eat KFC after.
That's a reward.
That's literally how I, when I first like lost all my weight, we used to like it gave me a couple of months, and my dieting started to slowly whittle down. And you were like, we'll go get KFC. Yeah, let's go get KFC.
And you eat what you want, as long as you keep under your calories.
I'll says he works from a PT only gym as well, so it's not just random gym goers in there. It is people who are there with other PTs as well. So
yeah, so what
gives you that benefit?
Yeah, what it does, what it takes away is the fear of the gym environment. Because that is the hardest part for anything for anybody to do. Sorry, to step foot in a gym because of the fear of getting judged and all that crap, even though that actually doesn't happen. No. I've had a lot of clients where they've had social anxiety and what have you, and it doesn't take long to get rid of it, but it does. It's I don't want to say it's an epidemic, but it's large. It's a really big problem with gym.
Pandemic.
It's a massive obstacle for people to overcome. Do you know what I mean? And unfortunately, each time they put it off, they're just putting themselves behind all the time. Do you know what I mean? But it's great for your mental health, so Yeah, give it a go.
And to clarify, me and Lee are both currently working out with Darren every week.
Yeah.
So,
for the most part.
As you can see, it's done wonders for us. To be fair, I am feeling stronger.
My aim is to lose 50 kilos this year.
Mine's to put 50 kilos on, but actually healthy muscle.
Yeah, you're stripping body fat, but muscle.
I don't want. I'm happy being
so
fat though.
Come quarterback.
I don't want to be quarterback. I did that shit. To be fair, with the offensive line we're going to have this year, yes. But I'm a part of that offensive line, exactly. So no.
You can protect me, there we go. I'll take you out to Estabula's.
Oh, Estabula's.
I should organise something for that.
Maybe our QB should think about doing that for next year. He gave us all a bag of sweets.
The QB should always look after his own line.
He gave us a bag of sweets at the party.
Good.
All the linemen. Well, actually, he dropped them on our table and said spread them between the linemen.
One bag.
Me and Lee pocketed the lot.
Two bags.
But with a snack size. Josh, are we?
Well, the normal size is snack size.
When I was QB, I'm pretty sure I got one a big box of fucking celebrations or something.
No, you brought a bag of massive. There were big bags of Harry Balls, I remember it.
Boy, that's why.
Right.
I think she got the other way. Lyman took QB.
The Div 1 final is going to be this.
Here we fucking go.
I think it's going to be.
These beans are cold.
The Vikings against. Against. I wonder if the Olympians make a jump back up.
Fuck off. Stop it right now. Fuck off. The London Olympians should not Let's make a back. Let's be. We'll be the team.
Do you think?
I'm fucking right to them.
Right, well, you asked me the question, so let me answer it. Right?
He's already answered it, Olympians.
No, you're
kidding. No, your first answer is what?
Shut up, man.
You've killed me. You've actually broken me, Bert, honestly.
It's going to be the Vikings against. Yeah, I'd say Blitzby, yeah.
And what happens when Blitzby gets promoted?
Well, yeah, I think. But I think that's a final, but I don't know who's going to win. That'll be the final. So where's Div 2?
Div 2 just a bit further down.
I think this is going to be. The North team is going to be President. This is the wind of Jack Curry podcast.
I ain't even fucking playing. Like, these are bad fucking calls.
That's their full name.
Wakefield District Raiders, yeah.
Why'd you put district in? What a waste of fucking space.
So I think. Hang on.
I'm hanging.
No, I think the Senators are going to take the North.
Yes.
I think they're going to make a big step up.
Senators or Wakey?
No.
Yeah, one of them will win the North.
No, Gator will win that.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm positive.
I don't know, like.
I'm positive.
You're positive?
No.
You're calling it?
Gates are doing it.
Call it.
Do you know what it is? Tenor that says Wakefield win the Northern League. The easiest tenor I've ever made. What's the best team in Wakey?
You have to spend it in
Wakey
wines,
though.
What'd you
say? Wakey Gates are going to go there and beat them away.
It's a gift voucher.
Yeah.
In the south,
I'm actually really bad at it because I've actually already said that I think it's in the league, and now I just want to pick up the Raiders.
I like the south, the two south teams which are complaining where they have to play cross division one.
Yeah, that's actually a rule. Do you know that rule?
They only have to drive an extra probably like 50, 60 miles, mm-hmm. And there's nothing compared to
when we have to travel to fucking Highland.
I don't know what's the south. I don't really know a lot of their teams. I know them, but I don't know them well enough. What do you think, Jack? Seems like you're a man of an opinion.
I actually called that mine out last week.
Which was?
I can't say them. Let me have a look at them and I'll re-list the names off of my head.
Last week it was Prem. I don't think you.
You said Gladiators, I think. If I remember rightly.
Colchester.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
I genuinely don't remember who I fucking went for. I think it might have been the top one, the middle one.
Somerset Wyverns are a decent team.
Who?
Somerset Wyverns. East Essex Sabres, possibly.
You're a decent who I went team. For.
Yeah. So, yeah, there you go. I don't think it answers your question, but there you
go. Who wins the Prem? Manchester Titans.
Manchester.
Fair. They're a pretty good team.
Blitz,
I did win last year.
I'm all about London Blitz, though.
Maybe one, you know what?
Is this you trying to get a move?
A move to blitz?
Yeah.
Nah, I wouldn't play. They got offensive linemen like 7 foot tall.
So what do you think happened if Blitzby actually won their division?
They'd turn into the...
They'd win.
They'd be the... They'd be cut, they'd,
I mean, like, with Baffa.
They'd change the name to London Non-Olympians.
Because if essentially if they got to the state of being promoted, there will be Blitz and Blitzby in the same Premiership League.
And that's how it'd be.
I reckon Baffa would have to do something about it.
Because they're down as two separate teams, aren't they?
That's fuck on league. Should we try the throw again? I'll get refreshed one. Put mine on the plate.
See if I'm intercepted.
You warned.
I've seen your quarterbacking. Oh, back down.
I'm just fucking throwing chicken all over the fucking thing. You go like. Don't tell you what, I'll fucking slap the next one of you.
Do it.
Fucking will and all. You know, I will and all. Oh well. Didn't get it because fucking big baldy heads in the middle.
There's three things in common. Well, one thing in common with all of the starting coaches.
apart from Wilkham.
No, the three starting coaches found us.
Oh yeah, the three Balder tears.
Yeah, but Wilkham's got his head shaved as well.
Well, it is now. Fuck.
That's why I hired him.
Just hire him.
If you're a man or woman who's suffering from hair loss. Come join the balance team.
You can be a coach.
Make balls great again. That's what I'm going to do.
You can take
over for a second. I looked up there and I thought it was a full moon. And I just realised it was just a reflection that took me over it.
You know what it is? So my hairline's actually really bad.
I embraced it. I was ready. Yeah, let's do it.
One of the most difficult things is...
I've paid for a haircut since I was 13.
Neither have I. I haven't paid for one ever. No, I actually paid for one haircut.
What, did you just run out?
No, my mum just...
He walks briskly. Stop that guy!
I literally paid for one haircut, and that was when, almost towards the end of COVID down south. So I just needed a haircut at that time.
So, who cut your hair?
My mum. She's a hairdresser. Oh, she used to be a hairdresser.
My mum used to be a hairdresser, but I don't get to cut my hair anymore. Personal reasons. For that reason there. Because people just look at you like that and go,
she missed a bit.
Your mum's a hairdresser. Missed a bit. That's it.
That was literally school for me.
When are the three children?
It doesn't really bother me anyway.
You are?
I work from home, so it doesn't bother me that much anyway.
That's fair. I mean, I go.
Standards. That's what that's
I just about. Got. I just got to look good from this angle here, which I don't anyway, so.
That's what we all have in common. I'm just looking at that camera there, just looking at Darren's head.
I'm bald.
The fucking light right above you as well.
I'm bald, so
it's fucking ruining you on there.
It's not though. I'm getting a tan.
I'll just tweak the brain a little bit over the whole podcast.
I'm gonna stop because it's gonna turn into a full and roast.
You're dead leg in a minute.
Yeah. You already have. Working okay. Out in the gym with Darren.
Anyway.
Right. Moving on. Briskly.
First guest podcast there was an assault happened.
Yeah.
World's fastest guest assault.
And fucking yeah. Dr. Evil over here.
To be fair, we're getting onto the actual real stuff that people actually care about now. You brought in KFC.
We did?
Yes.
We got to make up our best fast food list. So start off with... What's the best fast food place which you'd go to if you could only eat there ever? That's the only fast food place you could eat.
Burger King.
Five Guys.
Oh, we're there.
Shot.
Now, you have to mention, do we have a budget?
Yeah, do we have to pay for this?
Yeah.
Oh, they've got Five Guys on.
You could only go to one fast food place ever again.
Yeah, but...
So, if you wanted some fast food... You could only go to that.
But you have place. To add the financial bit into it because it's £10 for a fucking
it's
burger.
Not like you have it every day.
Can we just say we're not paying for it, so which right, one okay. Go to?
I was just saying if you could only choose one place, even if you're still paying for it, you could only go to that place. Like it's not like you eat
Five Guys because you shouldn't be eating that shit constantly anyway.
Better. Five Guys with the Cajun fries, bacon, double cheese.
See, in my head now, I'm like...
Rules.
To be fair, the standard adult burger is two burgers. That's
awesome.
You know, in my head, I'm like, yeah, Five Guys is the best for that. But realistically, for a different choice of food,
definitely
Burger King's better. Their chili cheese bites are insane. I don't care what anyone says.
I prefer the burgers over compared to someone like McDonald's. I prefer the burgers.
McDonald's is shit.
Yeah.
Like, I eat that, and yes, I'm full.
I'm not full. It never fills you.
Are you kidding?
McDonald's never fills you.
I bloat like a fucking.
But McDonald's breakfast is great.
No! I disagree.
It's a good hangover cure.
It's not.
It fucking is.
There's food shit now. They got rid of the wrap. They got rid of the fucking big breakfast.
Jack used to work at McDonald's, by the way.
I did. Like fucking nearly 20 years ago.
This is why he's kicking off.
It's just disgusting. The breakfast wrap was the fucking bee's knees.
Nah, I didn't like the wrap. It was too sweet.
I'm going to come over this fucking table and teach you a lesson. The what?
The wrap.
Oh, mate, you are like...
I am rock hard. Shut up.
Yeah, suspension for what you did on the podcast.
And they fucking writer will. Fucking if you keep on telling me breakfast is good for McDonald's.
Is this what the Unsportsmanlike conduct thing's about?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's good. Well, it's mainly for the Jack. To be fair, there is a Taco Bell which has opened recently as well.
Yes, and I've been there.
Never been to a Taco Bell.
I've been to one in America. I liked it.
So good.
But I wouldn't go there.
So what did it sell?
It's Tex-Mex. It's Mexican.
It's like burritos.
Ooh, nice.
Burritos, tacos.
I tell you what, next podcast we do, I'll get it and we'll watch it. You can watch me eat it on the podcast from home.
Thanks.
It's expensive. It is out of the way.
Can you just set that chair there?
It's 5 minutes.
How expensive is it? Because I haven't been...
We went and paid about £30 the other day, but we bought fuckloads.
Because in America it's quite cheap.
Well, yeah, it's like you know when you get like a cheeseburger from Mackey's, it's like a quid. It's like that for a taco.
That's about the same.
Right. Okay.
It's like a dollar for a taco. You can get.
You can get like hard shell or.
Which I love at Taco Bell is the quesadillas.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
The best thing I think. I'm not a big fan of the tacos, but.
I'm more of a burrito guy. I can eat like four burritos.
Quesadillas. They're all right, but they're not the best.
It's just cheese and meat.
Really. Pretty much.
With whatever else you want in.
I mean, Mexican, like, as
that's,
it goes
that's
for food.
The whole line, like, it's just cheese and meat.
Really. Is Mexican food not, like, up there as, like, one of the best foods?
No.
Yes.
I could eat that every day.
I love Mexican food. So you got chili, you got enchiladas.
Are you talking Mexican food in terms of if you're actually having Mexican food or fast food?
Mexican food.
So actual Mexican food, it's great.
Depends on Speedy Gonzales.
If it's fast food, like Taco Bell, it's not as good. There's definitely better fast food.
So what you're about? It's not. You're not talking about Mexican cuisine.
We're talking about Taco Bell. That's why
we can go to Five Guys and get a really good burger, or we can go to McDonald's and get a pound one. That's very similar to going to Taco Bell to get a cheap $1 fucking taco.
Oh, yeah.
Or go to Mexico and getting shot. Mexican cartel just take your tacos from you.
It's just because we're talking about fast food, that's why.
Oh, class.
Yeah.
As fast food, I agree with the...
I like it.
Five Guys is awesome.
Yeah, Five Guys is
awesome. Five Guys is insane.
But it's just expensive.
I think at least two or three of our games last season, I went straight to Five Guys after an eight, like a burger.
I get one a month at least. I'll go take Jade to Middlesbrough and back.
The best fast food is the one that kind of varies what it does. Because you don't just want burgers all the time or just chicken all the time, do you?
You just go to Five Guys and just order chips as a meal. That's the thing.
I'm going on, yeah. But it's just...
Cajun fries.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Burger King is a good shout because it does burgers and the chicken. And the chili cheese bites, obviously.
I don't rate the Burger King chicken, though.
What have you left drinks for?
You're a dickhead.
But look at that! I mean...
I don't rate Burger King chicken. I prefer McDonald's chicken over Burger King chicken.
Do you want a drink, Lee?
No, I'm alright. I've got water.
Yay. You get that water intake in, lad.
It's got water, because if he takes anything else, he'll just fucking die.
Third bottle of water today.
This has got water in it.
Good.
Drink a lot of water.
This has got
carbonated water in it.
Just a
fake what?
It's
it's got
it's carbonated water. It says carbonated water and it says colour.
It's carbonated black water colour.
No, that's caramel, actually. Maybe that's what the jerseys should be. Caramel colour.
No, I've eaten the Mars bar, right?
It's not like the American, how the
caramel is not that colour.
32 and stuff like that.
Do what?
How the Americans do the colours, just chemicals, like red 32 is what it's...
Oh, this one's got...
sounds like a play call.
This one's got a code as well. It's caramel E150D, which sounds like a run play to the right behind number 64.
To be fair, in America, they still use a lot of chemicals which actually are classified in Europe and the UK as cancer. Like, they cause cancer, like red 22, I think, is one.
To be fair, though, they're like...
Yellow 15.
They do a cull, so...
Okay.
Anyway. Let's move on. Wait there, so wait there. Obviously, we've clarified.
Five guys.
Yeah. But what about in America itself? I mean, I've been America. You've been America? Have you been America? Mm-mm. You've not been America?
No.
That's a shame. Not Team Europe.
I've had all this since 2007, you know.
Oh, yes.
To be fair, I do rate the pancake breakfast at McDonald's in America. It's a pancake infused with syrup, and it's like a McMuffin.
You're a peasant, man. Look at you with your McDonald's breakfast, man.
I know, I'm just saying, like, the two pancakes infused with syrup, and then it's just like a McMuffin breakfast.
This is, like, the third time you've mentioned this on a podcast.
This is good.
And we've only done four.
Yeah.
Denny's breakfast. Pancake balls. Insane.
The Waffle House is really good.
The hotel I was staying at, they had a... This is class. They had a Texas-shaped waffle maker. You pour your own mix in, turn it over, and you get your own Texas waffles. You see, demolish like four or five of them before each practice.
That's the thing which I think America does really well with their hotels. They all have complimentary breakfasts.
Yeah, 100%.
And you can get your fruit and stuff like that. You can get waffles. You can get like...
what's a fruit?
Can you tell these two are on a calorie deficit?
I don't count calories.
Really, so. Just be one food.
Feed me.
But yeah, they just do hotels good.
Yeah,
like it's expected. Like if it doesn't have it, then it's very... you're probably paying like $10 for the night.
Mm.
Yeah, true.
It's a motel instead of a hotel.
Ooh,
oh, no, rhymes. Sonic.
Oh, Sonic.
Sonic Burger, like Sonic Fast Food Point. That's actually amazing.
He's just shouting food out at this point. Like, to be fair, I was like a...
I was talking about games. But we moved on.
Straight on this fucking Sega.
I literally forgot about Sonic, but Sonic Fast Food Place. It's actually really good. It's... you just drive up, order all the cutting to come, they bring out, and then you go. Like, it's...
that's
like,
fast.
Like, you can sit in it inside, but it's like one of them old style ones. Like, you know, when you've seen the movies, or like the McDonald's movie one.
Yeah.
Like, where you just pull up to like a car park space, talk to a speaker, then they bring it out, and then you go.
That was like our experience at KFC before.
It was, yeah.
It's called a drive-thru, Lee.
Was that more a drive-in?
Drive-in is more, it's more accurate, really. But yeah, no, to be fair,
I know what you're on about. They're dazed and confused. They do want that.
Yeah, like, it's dirt cheap and it's just good.
If you could try any fast food abroad, what would it be? So, like, I want to try In-N-Out Burger. That's, like, a big thing in America. And everyone talks about it. And apparently they have like great burgers. Also, is it White Castle? Their burgers?
You'd be watching Harold and Kumar.
You're going to get the one with the fucking, like, 30 burgers on.
That's pretty sound to me, yeah. That's, like...
it's, like, $30, you know.
Pre-game lunch.
Anywhere that sells wings.
Oh, you know, yeah.
All day.
Hooters. Good wings. Good wings.
I want to try Hooters.
No.
For the food.
Sure. For the sports
bar. I got another good America story. We went in there and name drop. Cecil Martin called ahead and got us a table. We all went in our jerseys and some Americans were just sat there asking us like what we're doing, everything. Bought us wings. Anyway, I looked over the wall and Cecil Martin had a picture on the wall with the Hooters girls. He was like a local there.
Nice.
We walked in there, about fucking 15 of us. Seat straight away, no issues at all. Wings were already ready for us. This man just fucking... I just feel like that's life goals, to have like Hooters in your back pocket.
Cecil, the Cecil your head coach?
Cecil Martin, top player.
Was he the head coach?
Yeah. He was the Team Europe head coach. He didn't really... I never saw him make any actual decisions. It was like he was the head coach, but then there was like coaches from all over Europe who were actually making like the gameplay decisions.
That's what they're there for.
And
well, the head coach doesn't do anything.
But he was like, it was like just the little benefits. Like he just rock up, you know, everyone was feeling ill one day. So like there was a bug, Connor Nicholson caused this illness. It was going around like a plague.
Scottish plague.
Like literally everyone was bedbound. It was brutal.
Was he dishing haggis out again?
That's what it was, yeah. Cecil rocks and drops down a crate of fucking Gatorade, you know, gets us all sorted out, you know, gets ready for practice. And after we finished the game, it was like fucking 12 o'clock at night or something. And obviously we know the rules in America. This man just rocks in with a crate of beer, just puts it down, goes, I didn't see it, and then walked away. And we're all just drinking, underage. I'm just kidding.
So Cecil, the police will be around soon.
Top coach, literally the epitome of football. He was a great player as well.
Mm-hmm.
Great player.
Who did he play for?
The Philadelphia Eagles. Big time. Name drop. Don't like Philly, but.
Philly cheesesteaks. Huh?
Philly cheesesteaks. Oh, no, it's just like turned back again. Yeah. I really like. They are amazing. But you only went to. You went to fucking Nebraska, man. You don't have shit there, man.
No, Brian, that's good.
Hello.
You get some good steaks.
Piece of fucking corn out of his fucking teeth.
To be fair, I actually did my second time I went over there. Second time I went over there, I took Jade out to like a restaurant for some food, and I ordered a steak. It was $10 for the steak, about this big. Like took up the whole plate, and then there was like separate plate for just chips and stuff like that. It was like $10.
It was a separate plate. Fuck me. That's
the whole plate. The whole plate was just a steak.
Yes, please.
Sounds like an absolute mistake.
Steak's just open. Awesome. If it was vegan.
It's just crazy. Like paying $10 for the side of the plate. Like the plate was bigger than this.
Well, I thought it was good that they gave you like the meat option and the vegetarian option at the same time.
Yeah, that's what they were
doing. True. Yeah, no, $10. Like, if you had to pay for that in the UK, it's probably like 60, 80 pounds, something like that.
Really? Was the steak, was
steak like this
big. And the steak was that good?
Yeah, it was brilliant.
What type of steak was it? It was a meaty one.
Cow.
Yeah, cow steak.
I can't remember, honestly. I just remember the size of it was huge because you know, this was probably 5 years ago now.
So was it a rump? Was it a filler?
Sirloin? Right next to the horse farm.
Sirloin. Porterhouse.
New York's
carrot. Goat.
A literary carrot.
You haven't seen any goats outside, do you?
Farmer Daryl. I haven't seen him in ages.
Yeah,
no, did they have like straw hats?
What? Who?
Straw hats and like dungarees.
Some of the rural farmers will have the dungarees. I haven't seen anybody in a straw hat.
Three teeth and sister wives.
You go down lower for the...
That's Texas, isn't it?
Alabama.
Everything's bigger in Texas.
Did I send you that clip when there was this guy going around asking questions to people from Alabama about like their sisters and stuff like that?
We're going to tag that right in. Right in here. Just so he knows. Lee about to put his fucking incest videos on.
So we get banned.
True.
I'm surprised we're not banned already. The last few podcasts have been pretty ruthless. We have not got like a line to cross. We kind of ripped that out on day one. I don't think there's anything else to input. So, our first game is in 3 weeks?
Something like that, yeah. 9th of April.
We have a training camp, not this Saturday, the Saturday after.
Mm-hmm.
The training camp's a 2-day camp. Well, realistically, it's not a full 2 days.
Saturday night, 7 till 10.
Saturday night, 7 till 10, film session. and like kind of a knowledge of the game and like learning stuff. It's really good, especially with us coming up to our first game the week after. So this will be a lot of game prep for us. The day after, we have a full camp that starts off with our PT down the gym for a 2-hour session or 1-hour session?
An hour and a half to strength and conditioning.
Hour and a half strength and conditioning, followed by some food. And then we head over and we've got loads of football practice. So I could go into it all, but it's like walkthroughs. And then it just kind of goes into all the technicals. And then more walkthroughs, lots of fitness. If you still want to like be a part of it and you're new to it all, come down. Like,
absolutely. There's an inquiry form on the website anyway.
Literally get yourselves down. Fair enough, you might not play the first game. You might. You never know. So it's worth doing. If you are interested, please do it. If you're not interested, then just fucking turn this podcast off now and don't watch it again.
No, if you're wondering what happens with the gym sessions, I don't know if a lot of teams do them. Is normally it is big lifts, as in your compound lifts. So you're looking at your bench, you're looking at your squats, you're looking at your deads, right? Then we move into more accessory work. So you're looking at your dumbbell work, really.
Yeah.
And then you've got a half-hour conditioning session. With me outside, we're looking at prowlers, med balls, battle ropes, tire flips, all that type of stuff. Do you know what I mean? And then we'll go down to practice. You have dinner and then go down to practice.
Yeah, I was talking to...
just really organised in the minute.
I was talking about talking to the head coach yesterday. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would kill me. Food before game, before practice? Nah.
But it's replenishing. You don't eat heavy.
Never ate before a game.
I didn't even eat before the Alphas game or during. Hardly's after. I drank a lot.
I didn't help me.
The night before, you should be carb loading then.
Nah.
You need to.
I didn't.
Nah. Because I don't want to be below. I want to look
even knackered then.
I want to look good in my jersey.
Because I don't want to shit myself on the field. Well, yeah, but, so I don't, if there's nothing in there, I can't.
Yeah, but that's because you've got like 27 different health conditions, you know what I mean?
that's literally the only reason why I don't eat before.
Yeah, I know, there is that.
So
like, shit yourself.
I don't have to worry about it then.
I think I'm like, I just don't, I fear of being like, being sick. I don't want that. So I'd rather be empty
stomach. I mean, I understand you don't want to feel heavy.
I lost so much weight in the Alphas game. It was insane.
Well, you were losing.
I weighed myself before and I weighed myself after. And if I did lose half a stone in that game.
So.
It was class. Weight loss for life.
So I've told you about muscle glycogen, haven't I? If you've got nothing in it, how are you meant to perform?
But I do perform.
You don't know.
I fucking do.
You're shite.
I fucking perform like a fucking king.
I was going to say something about me and the... like losing stuff on that day. I lost brain cells.
Yeah. Concussion protocol number 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's how we do it. Football. Woo. Do it, yeah.
So you can remember your marriage twice.
Well, what were we talking about? Lee was looking for something.
I couldn't find it.
We were talking about camp.
We were talking about camp, yeah. Sorry, Lee.
I ended up looking at Alabama memes.
Lee was just checking memes out.
This is some dark web stuff.
No, I literally... That's sick. I think it sent it to Jade just because I troll her, because she used to live in Florida at one point.
Right.
That's even worse than Nebraska. Fuck me.
She started in Nebraska, went to Florida, and then went back to Nebraska, essentially.
No, Dalton,
yeah, somehow.
Isn't she the winner?
The weirdest thing is, she meets a hell of a lot more Americans here than you realise. She's
sorry,
like, but not as much as not as but not as many as she would if she was in America.
Just in general,
how many of them I realise?
Just you don't like the amount that she realises that there's people here who are from Earth, from in Dallas for some reason.
Mm.
She met
two people over here who were on a church retreat from America.
Naturally.
She's met like 10, 12 people who went to the theatre.
Right. To the theatre? what do you guys do in your days of theatre? What are you going to watch?
She works at the theatre.
Oh, right, okay.
It's not because of the squaddies, is it? Not because of Carrick and that.
Possibly, but it's just weird. Just the amount of Americans that she meets in Darlington.
Maybe like she just like attracts them. Like I remember when I was in Germany, I found more English people than I thought I would. Yeah. Very similar to that. You'd be walking down and they'd be chatting and be like,
fucking double take. Like, I just heard someone, I can understand someone, like, what the fuck you're saying.
Mm.
So I get that, but I don't know. Maybe it's just because you don't, like, maybe because you're, like, not expecting it. That's when you overhear it.
It's Darlington, that's why. That's why I don't expect it.
Mm.
It's Darlington. Why would it be Darlington? Like, yes, somewhere more south.
Why not?
So where is, do you know where they're from? Are those the American?
California. There's some from, I think she's met some from, like, Wyoming.
Has she met Patrick before? Yeah, that's another person I've done on the list.
You got a few New Yorkers. I think it's been one from Texas.
Welcome horns.
Yeah, it's just odd, like, just hearing, like, how many people from America she meets in Darlington.
Mm.
To be fair, it's weird seeing how many Darlington people are in Darlington.
Sure. Darlington isn't a people, it's just a mixture.
It's all related.
It's fucking rough. I had to cover stuff up in my car before I came into this house, just in case I got robbed. The car's literally out there. Right,
where's my food shopping, isn't it? I don't have my food shopping.
What do you do about Aycliffe
then? I don't live in Aycliffe anymore. I live somewhere way worse. No one does shit in Aycliffe, man.
They do.
No, they don't.
They do. They just get suspended. Have you seen the retrobates? Hang on. Have you seen the retrobates we've got in our squad that are from Aycliffe? And you all know it.
They've all done their bit to society.
Debt to society.
Community service.
I mean, what can you say? Like, guys are dedicated to the cause.
To what?
Being absolute fucking legends.
Yeah, they are. The good lads. The good lads, really.
Bless them. Oh, I'm fucked.
Tired.
So, what else have we got?
Is there anything that you're watching at the moment that you find interesting, TV-wise?
I've just finished The Last of Us.
Class. Spoilers, don't watch.
Obviously, that's the finale that's just happened, so...
You know the worst part is about The Last of Us? Is I knew how it ended.
Yeah, I did.
Ten years ago.
Yeah.
I haven't watched it, though.
He's not watched it yet.
So,
I'm watching Suits right now.
Stop. What are you going to do? There may be some spoilers here. So when I wave, you can probably put your sound back on.
Is it a good representation of the game?
It's what they wanted to do with the game.
Well, I can imagine they...
From what I've heard, it's good.
It's what they wanted to do with the game. Some of the stuff they changed is stuff that they wish they'd done. There was episodes where it finished and I was like, that was amazing. And there was moments where an episode finished and I went...
That reminds me of The Walking Dead.
I wish they had done this instead.
Because The Walking Dead was cack.
Yeah, The Walking Dead was shit. Last few seasons.
The Walking Dead died off well, but they just went
away from the comics. Because Frank Darabont had it, and then when he left...
There was a fucking tiger.
They went away from the comics, which... The tiger's in the comics.
That's stupid. Yeah,
it's actually...
That's fucking...
The comics were class. The comics are, you know, like how Laurie got pregnant and...
Yeah.
The baby rips out of her as a zombie.
Yeah.
In the comics.
Yeah.
Also, Cal gets shot through the air, which I know happens to the thing, but you actually see through it in the comics.
And I didn't watch it that far ahead. That's a spoiler for me.
You're not going to watch it.
No, it's going anyway. You can't watch it within 24 hours, you're not going to. That's the rule.
So
you're watching Suits at the minute?
Suits, and Suits is amazing. Breaking Bad as well.
Suits is
I feel like we're on actual older programs now, so Suits there's the wave. You can start listening again.
Yeah, I'm just started Suits.
Harvey Specter is a legend.
Yeah.
As is Lewis Litt.
I never watched it.
Mate, you're missing out.
Yeah.
Oh, you are. It's class.
Hey, I haven't watched The Office, but still haven't.
You haven't watched The Office?
No, I've only seen clips. It's one of the shows which I haven't watched anything of it. I've only watched clips, and I don't think I could get into that show.
It's your humour.
I know it's my humour, but...
You've got such a dry sense of humour. Like, it's just you.
If I'm watching something, I can't watch something, like, just because it's my humour. I don't... Like, that's why I'd watch clips of it.
Right. Lee doesn't watch his podcast either.
Yeah, I don't.
Me neither.
I have to listen to it, though.
Little bastard.
I don't know why I watch stuff which I can actually get hooked into and then just binge and then I just try to stop.
Paradise PD, one of the most messed up shows I've ever seen in my life.
Paradise PD is class.
Have you is seen this the that? Cartoon thing on Netflix?
Mate.
Yes.
It is insane.
Have you seen any of the Disenchanted?
No.
What?
You should watch Disenchanted. It's like Futurama, but set in medieval times.
You've told me about this.
Oh,
It's really good. It's not as batshit crazy as Paradise PD, but it is really good.
So what about just playing old Rick and Morty?
It was good in the first few seasons, but...
Don't you fucking say it.
I haven't watched past season 3.
Never watched it.
And I feel like this, it's some of the humour to Paradise PD, just...
Yeah, I think you explained that when you would tell me what Paradise PD, and I've just been scarred since.
Yeah, I'd say after
that. Mate, it's mental.
After season 3, it's when.
I can't believe you're watching that, but you haven't watched, like, Rick and Morty.
Sorry.
That's literally, like. Rick and Morty's so dark. It's ridiculous. So dark. I was watching a clip today.
Paradise PD is worse than Rick and Morty.
You what?
Paradise PD is really? Worse than Rick and Morty. Yeah.
Mate, just watch it.
It's dark, but not dark at the same time, where, like, Rick and Morty's dark more it's so than anything. So
Paradise PD Paradise is what...
is Family Guy and Rick and Morty.
It's what Family Guy wants to be, but can't.
It's Family Guy and Rick and Morty mixed together, I would say.
It must be good if he's fucking... It is really good. Over it.
Just watch one episode and you'll be laughing your ass off.
I'll watch
it. Or you'll be like, what the fuck is this shit? There's no in between. You laughing your ass off, or what the fuck is the issue, or both. There's no in between.
Really, he just said.
You're probably going to be both of them, but there's nothing. They're the only two options.
I'll watch it, and the next podcast we can talk about it.
Crazy.
I watch one episode. If I like it, I watch the whole season in one night.
It's three seasons. Watching... I think it's three seasons right now.
I watched three seasons.
I'm on the third season.
It's class.
Actually, on the talk of TV shows. And now that we've got Darren here, I don't know when we'll eat him back. Blue Mountain State.
I like the way it is. I don't want it back.
You don't want it back?
No.
Not after watching Thadland.
If they followed on the actual TV series from there, I think it'd be pretty good.
Thadland was just a mess, wasn't it?
Thadland, it was hilarious.
It was it was a mess. It
didn't need to be a part of Blue Mountain
State. I tried watching Jack Reacher. And I couldn't take it serious watching it. Because all I could think about was that.
Well, I've read all the Jackie novels.
I can't think of... Like, when I'm seeing the actor play, I can't think of him anymore.
He's brilliant as Jack Reacher, though.
Step he
is. But he says stuff.
Okay!
He pulls a face. And I look at him and I'm like, that's that. He's literally forming slowly.
I'm expecting him with how throw condoms for his QBs.
Oil change.
And I'm paying.
Oil change.
Oh, remember that? Remember the instance with Durham years ago?
I've called them out on this fucking podcast.
Can you remember that? I say that meme with the oil change. Come to Durham says oil change. It's just a picture of that.
He also got the high pitched scream whenever he's getting, like, losing it.
Yeah, yeah.
That first episode when they're sticking the Oreos cookie. Up the backside.
Barney's up in the background.
Just eat it.
The finger. Oh, his best mate. Yeah.
She just goes like,
what a fucking show. That's the one with
The show is class. There's a lot of football in it and it's still fun.
I was first but brought
the head, I love the head coach. Marty Daniels is awesome.
How many times have you stole a speech before a game? That's a Marty Daniels speech.
The first one in the opening episode, I've used it.
Go on, reiterate it for the people who watch it. Please reiterate it.
To be fair, rate their intro, the intro to Blue Mountain State.
The music's the best.
10 out of 10.
100%.
10 out of 10.
I want
to hear Darren say that.
No, but have you listened to the song by itself compared to the intro? The intro's so much like a colour above the
just. Oh,
yeah, it is. Yeah,
sound effects just make it.
Yeah, but you know when that happens when you listen to there's an intro of a song, and then you listen to the actual song of it. Do you feel like you're being cheated? Like that, in other words, when it goes past the bit of the intro.
I feel like it should
stop, but then it's it doesn't necessarily always build up. I really like the actual song, which
Red Theory.
It's like the,
but it's not the actual like music part of it. It's not the words, but it's like the music part of it.
The whole thing though, it's like when you have the full song on, it's like that. Watching it's like an extended edition.
Yeah,
It's like a treat.
It's good. It's just not as good as just the theme song itself. Like I think if they had the sound effects in the song, it'd actually make it a lot better.
class up bit, innit?
Or the strapping over the belts.
Yeah.
Or the, I think it's gunshots in, or no, that's the belt one actually. Where the, it sounds like a reload and yeah, but gun sort of thing.
Play it. So what were we saying?
My father's balls, sir.
No, he says he's talking about winning, isn't he? He says, oh, winning is a perfect one. And in some cases, he was right. And then, yeah, then he says, oh, where are we from? Where are you from? Mountain goats. Wyoming, sir.
Here we go.
Dad, same question.
This is, I'm pretty sure it's on Amazon Prime right now. We have to watch it with adverts.
It's on freebie, innit?
I might make Emily watch it. It's just insane.
She just mining.
Yeah, she's a fucking prick. So I'm hoping that at this point, Lee puts the video in. Yeah. Clapping so that you can see. I hope. He tells me it is, but I think he just wants me to just clap like an idiot.
2:30. Yeah.
That's funny.
I think that's one of the best intros to anything ever.
Guess what? I'm going to fucking watch
Friday
all
Nights.
Week.
I love Friday Night Lights.
Friday Night Lights.
I don't think the intro... I like the intro, but it's not...
I love it.
It wouldn't be one in my top five.
I love it.
My...
Okay, so you're on TV shows or just American football stuff?
Intros to shows.
Right. Sopranos.
Yes.
It's got to be up there.
I haven't watched it, to be fair, but...
Game of Thrones.
Yes.
The intro is really good. Really good.
I actually never finished Game of Thrones. I
fucking God, we're going to fight now, Lee.
Season 4. I told you about this. I binge watched it because everybody was away. I got season 4. I was bored of it. I couldn't get it.
You should probably watch them all at once.
Yeah.
You should watch
I just don't enjoy the show. But I need... So this is why I like Suits and stuff like that. Or Friday Night Lights I binge watched.
I actually haven't watched all the Friday Nights.
So there's an anime to watch. I binge watched something called Naruto and the Naruto Shippuden. And that was...
It's anime stuff, isn't it?
Yeah. That was about over 1,000 episodes. And yeah. I did that in about a month.
You love a cartoon, you like...
Jay hasn't seen it in months.
Yeah, that was before I was married, to be fair. As I was on university when I just
when it was a young bachelor.
I was at university, didn't go to any lectures, just stayed at home, played CSGO and
that's funny
stuff. I paid about 27,000 in debt, 28,000 in debt uni fees.
To watch Naruto.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Hey, I got a level pass. 4 from it by not going. I still passed my first year exams. Which yeah.
I watched the whole of Sopranos when I told me it's sailing Norway. I used to just sit and watch it on my phone. You sent me that. What was that? That thing we used to watch illegal programs on.
We never did that, Jack.
What was it called though?
Yeah.
We never did that, Jack.
Okay. If you were to watch it, what would it be called? If it
was. Yeah, if I was like, don't want to watch
HBO Max.
You can't get that over here, Darren. How did you used to? How did you not
watch
it?
It was called Cartoon something.
Cartoon HD.
Cartoon HD, fucking class.
It's not around anymore.
I watched Sopranos literally every day. I used to go for a walk around, get my shopping in, a little walk around the scene. It got a bit cold, it's Norway. Went back home, I literally just whacked on the fucking Sopranos, watched about 4 or 5 episodes, had a nap, and then went to
practice. What you need to watch, because you've been in Norway, is watch Lilyhammer with Silvio's in it. From The Sopranos.
All right, okay.
So he has to leave New York. He's playing a gangster in it, obviously. He leaves New York and goes to Norway to get out of the way, and then becomes one of the main gangsters there.
So have you ever watched Tulsa King?
With Stallone?
Yeah.
I've watched the first episode.
Watch the rest of it, because that just sounds like that. But okay. With Tulsa.
Have you guys seen Superstar?
Yes.
I love that show.
Is this something that's on ITV too?
I don't know, I watched
it on Netflix.
No, then I haven't.
Slash illegally as well.
You can watch it on Netflix.
You can watch it on Netflix.
Do you have Netflix?
It was because
I have Netflix, but I haven't got the special stick that goes in to make the Netflix work better.
I don't Netflix. It's just on normal Netflix.
Alright, okay. So why do you watch it like illegally then?
Because it wasn't out on the Netflix the last season, which I wanted to watch.
All right. Okay.
Ah, so he's just...
season 5, which I think is on there now because it was a few years ago. But it was. To be fair, that show ended in the best. The end of that show is actually brilliant.
This attic's about to get raided. Honestly.
Yeah.
That's why we're not live.
Yeah.
Can you imagine getting spotted? So funny.
Straight in there, like a monster scene when you hit the window.
Yeah, that's it for you. Superstore is like a Walmart or a Best Buy sort of thing. Walmart is a store based around Walmart, but it's just about the employees and it's just talking shit.
It's on ITV too. Maybe they wear blue shirts.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there's like
Brett is the best.
I mean, I've never really been interested in it.
Brett's good. Older shell.
It's good.
It used to be on before Family Guy.
Yeah, it's good.
I'd say definitely Brett is the best character.
Mm.
Man.
Brett or Norma.
You need to watch The Office, by the way.
You need to watch Sopranos, you dick.
You need to watch Sopranos. So then, your top five shows.
I watched Peaky Blinders, binge watched all that.
Top five shows.
Mm-hmm.
At the top. Sons of Anarchy.
Good show.
I love Sons of Anarchy.
What about you?
Top show. I'm actually gonna say Superstar. I got really
like
invested
it?
In the story.
I think so.
I thought so.
I got really invested in the story. That's why it's.
There's a story.
Yeah, the overarching story.
It's you should. I'd say what.
Star.
Say, super one. Quit your job and just go work at Tesco. You'll have the time of your life.
Yeah, no, that's probably my top one. But there's probably so much I'm forgetting about, which I've loved.
I mean,
I've mentioned shows that people really love, like Peaky Blinders.
Mm-hmm.
Breaking Bad was good.
But what's your top five?
Well, that's just it. Superstars in that. Okay. BMS is in that. Right now, Suits is probably in it as well. That's three, I think.
They're fucking whicking this pen out.
Chairman boss for all that. Surprised not behind me here.
Just trying to remember what shows I watched. I forget about them because I binge watch shows and I just never remember them.
Friday Night Lights is up there, but it's not my favorite. It's like number
I
five.
I enjoyed Friday Night Lights, but I wouldn't put it in my top five.
Cool.
I really like the music. The music's like my pre-game song. I listen to that at least 10 times before game.
Was that on your wedding?
That was on my wedding.
It was on your wedding, yeah.
I had Your Hand in Mine. I had that playing for my before Emily's song came on before she walked down there.
Yeah. Great day, that.
Good time.
Disenchanted. That's one of them. Paradise PD.
Fuck, man, you just like naming all the things we've already talked about.
Yeah. So, you know, for me, you'll know that I don't watch stuff because I don't want to actually get invested in something because I will just binge watch it and it's a really bad habit.
What do you think of The Ring? Like Lord of the Rings.
Oh, I
never a fan.
I never actually watched
them. I don't
like Lord of the Rings.
I enjoyed the games. One of the games, the Twin Tower one.
I don't think I want. Let's not talk about the Twin Towers.
The three movies about war, don't get me started. Right. Those that know me know that I can't stand Lord of the Rings because it's basically three movies about walking.
Maybe if they were
the first one.
What about The Hobbit?
Hang on. The first one, they're just walking. Second one, they might trip a little.
There's trees.
The third one, they'll climb up a mountain, throw the ring, and done.
The trees are walking.
When
in one of them.
They could have just what is it? Where Gandalf?
Ubered.
Yeah, they could have just got on that bird thing or wherever it is and just went to Mordor.
Books so,
Harry Potter.
Yeah,
the movies.
Books are better.
I thought they were good, but
I love Harry Potter.
I love Harry Potter. It's class. Harry Potter World's mint. Butterbeer shit though.
Is it?
The one down in London is yeah. I bought a thing. You get the cup with it. It was like £5 a drink or something. Something ridiculous. Literally tastes like just
piss. Probably worse than Disney.
I mean, Disney's just expensive as fuck anyway, isn't it?
Actually, not Disney, it's Universal, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Probably worse than that.
That's what it was. Universal down on...
I mean, like the...
Oh, right.
The one which people would go to. Like, the one which is known. Don't know what to say.
So, you think Flying the Eagles.
Mm.
But, like, in that, like...
Would that have got them there?
I tell you what, we'll talk.
Would that have got them there?
We'll talk when this podcast off because I'm going to say something that's going to be very controversial.
And in Return of the King, hang on.
I'll clip it.
And in Return of the King, right? How many endings did they need?
All I'm saying is,
Carlos Riccani. How many endings were there?
The Eagles.
How many endings were there in Return of the King?
Like,
was it about eight?
Yeah. But the Eagles.
Just a bit of extra walking.
The Eagles are a being. They're their own being. So
even the trees walked in those movies.
The thing is, right? You were literally saying that they should have used them, because the Eagles didn't offer. They used the Eagles to fly them somewhere. So
they used the elephants.
They used the trees.
They used the
tree. They didn't. The trees offered to help, for one.
Did they use them? Did they use them?
No.
Pretty sure.
The trees helped. The Ents helped. I can't believe we even talk about this.
It's a controversial topic.
It's basically just loads of people to try and get the steps in. That's all it is.
So what would you have done?
It was a free trip to
New Zealand. Not watched it because it was shit. I don't like Lord of the Rings. Pants.
Wow.
Okay, so let's change topic.
Go watch Superstar.
The Marvel Universe.
Oh, fuck off. No.
No?
It's gone on too long.
Stupid.
I mean, like, the actual good one after the final end.
Endgame, sound. I mean, No Way Home was great from Spider-Man.
The new one's coming out last, actually.
Another one.
Yeah, but so there's been all the TV shows, and some of the movies have been shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they've lost out on the main actors, which actually helped make it really good.
Do you feel like they're just trying, a lot of stuff they're trying to do is just being super, super political?
No, I wouldn't say that.
No, I think they want to try to be more inclusive, but it's not necessarily a political standpoint.
I wouldn't, yeah.
Do
I wouldn't
you also feel that. Like it's a bit childish?
What?
I'm going to say it. I think Marvel's got a more childish thing to it. Like, they're trying to... They're
superheroes, aren't they?
But Batman's, like, not a fucking childish thing. He's still a superhero.
Yeah, but the DC world pants now.
It is. But let's go back...
Now, I love Marvel, but Batman's my favourite movie. I love the Bale era. It was outstanding.
That was, yeah. Dark Knight was insane, yeah.
But then I like Michael Keaton.
Yeah. I mean, all of Batman's, but I mean, you literally listen up. Even fucking, yeah, what's cool. His name?
Clooney. No, you're right.
Alan Clooney. That was a class Batman.
It was fucking shit.
Fucking Arnie is there. It's a freeze.
Chill. Fucking chill, man.
Oh, what a movie.
Deadpool's good.
Deadpool is good.
Yes.
Deadpool, class. That's, to be fair, Deadpool, Ryan Reynolds as Deadpool is one of the things which you don't.
Yeah, but that's just Ryan Reynolds. That's just Ryan Reynolds being Ryan Reynolds in every movie.
It's also the same with Free Guy.
Yeah.
It's because class.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is.
Have you seen Free Guy?
No.
Should watch it. It's really good.
Have you got Disney?
I think it's on Netflix.
I use someone else's Disney.
Watch it. It's really funny.
Right, your top five TV shows.
TV shows.
Let me tell you mine.
Go on.
I've got six. I can't decide on the last one.
What is it, Big Man?
So I've got Sopranos top.
Yes.
Lost.
Yes.
Friends.
I don't like Friends.
That's why they're mine. So Friends.
You're telling them projector use.
Yeah, I know. Friends, because it's timeless. Game of Thrones, and then I can't decide on the US Office or Big Bang Theory.
Office above Big Bang.
Fucking right. Shit. I wouldn't even put Big Bang Theory on there.
Yeah, it's pretty shit.
Is this Jack's list?
So you're going to put Big Bang in the top five now instead?
I might, yeah.
Do it, mate.
No, I won't, because I can't do that at The Office, because The Office is my favourite.
The Office is so much better. It's not your favourite, obviously. Yeah,
it's my favourite. That's not in order.
It's not in order.
Yeah, but if it is in the Office, must be...
So you're saying The Office is better than Sopranos?
I didn't say that.
But you said it's your favourite.
Yeah, but we can take out, since he's switching Office or Big Bang, that they're the bottom ones.
Yeah, they're definitely the bottom ones, but then he sat there going, The Office is his favourite, but I don't see him at the top. You wrote from top to bottom.
Notes.
Lost one is just one which is just confusing me. It's just,
I'm Lost would be a
hole. Like a button in the hole or something like that.
No.
I don't know, I've just...
crashed a plane and just appeared.
I actually watched like two or three seasons of it, but I don't remember at all.
That was the originating of a binge.
Prison Break.
No.
Early season Prison Break. Air Break. No. Prison Break.
Sounds like fucking a new type of Bake Off in prison.
So what's your top five then, Jack?
Oh no, yeah, he's giving me shit.
I can't hear
the UK office.
Sons of Anarchy, Sopranos. Band of Brothers.
What a show!
Actually, you know what? I'm retracting Band of Brothers to the top.
Okay then.
100%.
I've been watching two seasons.
It's 8 episodes.
There's a Pacific.
That's like
the extended one. I think I can't remember what it is. It's like 30 hours or something like that.
Yeah, that's like just normal Band of Brothers. Because they always have extensions at the end.
Yeah.
Where the actual original like people talking.
Yeah, I watch through all of it.
Wild.
It's like
an absolute roller coaster of emotions. What a fucking series. Number one.
Good show.
Then Sons, then Sopranos, Friday Night Lights is fifth, and then fourth, the other one on your list, Game of Thrones. That was it. No sixth or, you know, not in the right order. I literally was dashing out there. Bah, 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 bah.
Well, isn't it great to be you, eh?
Okay.
And I didn't even watch all Friday Night Lights, I went on fifth.
Let's do movies. Since that was just...
You can't do it. It's hard to do that in movies.
I reckon.
Best sports movie.
Best football movie.
Yeah, right. Best football movie.
Longest Yard.
Nah, Remember the Titans. Because I'll always remember the Titans.
Try to think.
Waterboy.
Space Jam.
Waterboy. Are you kidding?
Yeah, of course I'm going
to be. Oh, okay. I was going to say, what about the Blind Side? It's pretty sound. Not as football-y as
no, because it's a raven.
Blue Mountain State.
No.
The movie. Thadland.
Is it technically a football movie or not?
Here's one for you. Friday Night Lights, the movie.
We Are Marshall is a great movie.
We Are Marshall is a great movie. Great football team.
Mm-hmm.
I know people who went over there, so.
I'm trying to remember Randy Moss. How many football movies I actually watched. I'm pretty sure it's only one or two.
Really?
We'll try and list them. So you got Remember the Titans, you got...
No, I watched
Friday Night Lights. You haven't what the...
I haven't watched Friday Night Lights movie either.
Why are we even talking to this guy?
Because he's our producer.
So, you haven't watched Friday Night Lights or Remember the Titans?
I might have done, but I don't remember the names.
I actually... Cool story.
Classy, you wasn't there.
Remember the Titans, I met Coach Boone.
You did? Good rest his soul.
Real Coach Boone. Big man, not Denzel. I wish I met Denzel. I think that would be equally as cool. But yeah, real Coach Boone. And you don't know who that is, and that's the disappointing part. We're a football podcast, for Christ's sake.
Watch it. Actually, didn't that's your to-do list this week?
Too busy.
Put on the background.
I could, but I might do. I might not. I'm probably too busy watching Suits.
I think I would.
Watch Remember the Titans.
I watch everything all at once.
This is my retirement from the podcast industry. 5 episodes.
This is my issue. I binge watch it until the finish. I don't like not having something on.
Mate, it's 1 hour, 2 hours at most.
Yeah, I'd rather just watch Suits.
Remember the Titans, the Friday Night Lights movie.
Mm-hmm.
We Are Marshall, Blindside, Longest Yard, Waterboy. Give me some more. When the game stands.
What's
tall.
The one with? Is that the one with?
Invincible.
Rudy. Yeah. Rudy. Yeah.
Brian's song.
You got two.
You got Concussion. Will Smith. That's a good one.
That's a great movie.
I've actually seen
it. And it's so real.
What about the one where they're doing?
It's all Steelers. Whatsoever. Yeah.
What about the one where they're doing the trades?
Oh, Draft Day.
Loads of people hate that movie.
It's a shit movie, that's why.
But do you know what, though? It's one of those movies where it's so bad, I enjoy watching it.
But he's watched Draft Day, but has not watched Remember the Titans or any of those other classics. You're a peasant.
Draft Day. Waterboy.
Draft
Day. Longest Yard. Good question. That's all I want to. I know that I've watched.
Sounds like your football career.
I might have watched.
You know what? That was good for you.
I always have guns.
Yeah, that was actually all right. Actually, that was. Yeah. Fuck me.
If you open it up to more sports, then I've got a little bit more, but
good one.
Space what a movie. Like, see, I thought you introduced it. I don't know. Oh, that's good. And the second one's brilliant.
Yeah.
Don't know if I watched it. I might have done. I usually just watch movies.
Is this a cave for it?
I want to just play a game of listing movies that he hasn't watched. I'll start.
Yeah.
Try it. List off 5 or 10 movies.
Remember, anything. Remember the Titans, Blindside.
What's your favorite sports movie?
Sports movie.
What's a sport?
Bend it like Beckham.
Bend it like Beckham.
It is a good.
Oh, no, it's not.
Football.
No, it's not. It looks like Jack Grealish, isn't it?
See, Charlie football.
Yeah.
It's not a funny movie though, but no. Best sports movie that I've watched, or favourite one?
Rocky. Have you with that? Have you watched Rocky?
By a Country Mile.
Have you not watched Rocky?
I've only watched parts of it. I'm still trying to think.
Sorry, we do have homes to go to.
Mighty Ducks.
What?
Mighty good Ducks. Shout out to Mighty Ducks. Mint.
That's like vintage.
It's a classic.
The hockey, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ice hockey, yeah.
That was like 2003.
They brought out a series, you know, on Disney Plus called The Mighty Ducks. It's actually really good.
I call Ollie and Harper. Ollie and Harper, the Bash Brothers, now. You should see the pair of them at safety, honestly.
Have you seen the series, well, though?
No.
It's actually really quite good. It's got the... Oh, what's it called? The I can't remember his name. The coach.
And Emilio Estevez.
Yeah. He's helping out, and he has an ice rink and whatnot. And he's bringing up a new team. It's actually really quite good.
Do you remember back in like the, I'd say like early 2000s, they had like loads of movies come out that had pets in, like sports movies. Like monkeys that could play like hockey, and like dogs that could play football and stuff like that. Do you know what else remember this? That's why I'm asking you. You didn't watch shit like that. You were fucking like, what were you like?
I didn't watch shit like that.
I remember a movie, and there was a chimpanzee, and he used to play ice hockey.
Oh no, I do know it was just one monkey. I know what you're talking about.
And there was a golden retriever in one of them as well that used to play a sport.
This was Disney in the fucking.
I don't know about the golden retriever one.
I'm gonna fucking find this shit. Give me fucking 1 second. Fucking chill yourselves.
Yeah, no, I watch terrible movies. Oh.
Sorry, I just got a message from Jordan McCabe, but I can't tell you what it is.
Show me what it is.
Joining Steam, I presume.
No, he's not.
I'd laugh if it actually was.
No, he's not.
No, but I think we're going down to watch his. Maybe we'll
see. I miss Jordan.
Jordan McCabe's the boy.
Boy.
Right, let's find this fucking monkey. I'm just going to type in Google monkey hockey and see what comes up. Something really good could come up, or something monkeypox. Monkey.
Yeah, that's a more recent thing, that.
Hockey.
I'm trying to think. Literally, I would say the Mighty Ducks.
That's it! It was called MVP, Most Valuable Primate.
It's probably pretty terrible.
Tell me you don't remember that.
I don't remember that. I do remember it.
I don't
remember the film. I just remember a monkey playing ice hockey. It's for everyone else.
In the second one, you had King Kong playing left tackle.
Funny enough. Well, yeah.
Yeah. I've told you plenty of times that I just don't watch what everybody watches.
You just watch shit instead.
Funny shit.
In your opinion, no. I'm amazed by it.
You like it?
All the fuck they're getting away with this. I know.
Every session you keep talking to me about it.
Yeah, but it's like a car crash. I can't stop watching it.
What's this?
Great.
Paradise PD.
I'm worth it watching now. I didn't want to, but
no. Put the trailer on for you and see what you think.
You've seen his asshole. That's my favourite bit, though. That's my favourite bit.
Do
It's hilarious. You're gonna love it, by the way.
For as long as I can remember, I've wanted to be. I've started watching this already. Paradise PD. I know exactly. Let me show you I can do this. No one wants to be a cop anymore. Hello? Don't you yell at me, you son of a bitch. Any of you idiots managed to do any police work yesterday? I pulled over a suspicious looking colored fella. You put a dog in charge of drug evidence? Drugs, drugs, look out, drug train coming through.
Crossover episode's brilliant.
Our mission is to wipe meth off the streets.
We are going in heavy.
Oh, why the hell did someone give this chicken a handgun?
I think I'm having a stroke.
I can make it clap, y'all.
Is that guy sucking his own dick?
Get your cuffs ready. I like to play rough.
Don't fuck your car!
I hope that everyone watching can hear us.
This is getting cut out.
Have you seen this asshole?
No!
How about you? You seen this asshole?
That bit just gets me every time. It's a funny episode, that one, like.
So, everyone watch Paradise.
Oh, just mental. Just mental.
What's in his asshole?
Best shows that randomly come across on Netflix.
Have we got anything else to cover up?
I don't know.
Have we got any more things we want to grill this guy on while we've got him?
Yes. Go for it. Ask away. What do you want to know?
Oh, she's pulled her face in there, mate. Expecting me to know what he was about to say. I don't know what he's about to come out with.
I thought you wanted to grill him.
Oh, I mean.
Quick fire.
Go for it.
Do you think Steelers will win the Super Bowl this year?
No.
Do you think they'll win it next year?
No.
Will they get
the year after?
Possibly.
Oh. It's impossible.
Playoffs?
It's on the draft. Yeah, they'll make the playoffs.
You really think so?
Mm-hmm.
Disagree.
How do you think the Texans will do?
Shit.
Every year. Do you think we'll win our first game?
Oh.
Durden. It's a win or lose situation.
I mean, yeah, there's two ways to go.
Another is we don't do ties.
Ends up in a tie.
Yeah, can you imagine? No overtime.
I'm going to put my neck on the line and say we're going to win. Just.
What's the score?
1-0. No. It's not possible score.
The score from the 2-yard line.
Yeah.
XFL rules.
What's that?
17-21.
To us?
Yes. That's why I said we'll win just.
Okay.
If you were playing, what number would you choose?
44. Already got that jersey, mate. Should have brought with me.
Should be playing this year.
No. My back.
Might have to.
No, with my back.
Line with us.
I've not had a knee for like 10 years.
Ah, oh, man.
You could play.
I couldn't.
I mean, you know what it is, though? I don't want to grill you, because I'd like to have you back on the podcast again.
You'll come on.
There's more stuff to talk about, and I feel like we could sit and, like, go through shit right now, but right now, where the club is, we should be looking forward, don't we? So, I ain't really got stuff to grill you on.
What's one thing that you
want... Leah,
what's one thing that you want people to know about this team this year?
Everyone's welcome.
But only if you're
in whatever capacity, that is, whether you're playing or not playing, non-playing staff as well, we need everybody.
Yeah, we're one big family.
But only if you pay your subs.
As long as it should be, yes.
If there's any debt collectors looking for a job this summer.
That's going to be part of my role.
I suppose if you could say one final thing to everyone watching about the team, about the season, about where you think the team's going to be, where the football's going to be in the UK, something like that. What'd you say?
It's just this team's going to surprise you this year. People think that we shouldn't be in Division 1, and that's fair enough, I understand that. But, as I said, we're not there just to make the numbers up. And we're going to surprise a few people.
Naughty. I like it.
Which rule do you think is most fucked up in that?
Unsportsmanlike conduct.
Yes. This is the right answer.
There you go.
The right answer was having a fingerless glove illegal.
Are we good to wrap up?
Yeah.
So
holding is the worst one.
Holding's the best one.
Holding's the worst one because it doesn't matter. Canadian.
Holding's the best one because you can tell how good an offensive lineman is about the amount of times they get called for holding.
I know that.
If they're a really good offensive lineman, they won't get called for holding.
No, if they're a really good offensive lineman, they know how to disguise it.
Yeah. I mean, I sometimes...
The same colour gloves and sleeves as the opposite team.
Oh, yeah. The world is wearing no gloves at all. Game changer. My life changed since I wore no gloves.
Just the fingertips.
When you look like Triple H. That's what you tape on your hands.
I'm going to start spraying water before each game.
Should have asked him that.
What? Oh, yeah.
Favourite wrestler.
So what we did last week, you should already know this because you probably watched the podcast, I hope. It's how we always test people. We put stuff in the podcast a week before, and then we'll call out and they'll go, anyway. So what we called out was favourite wrestler, back in the day, or whenever you want, really. Mm-hmm. And after that, what would you rather get? Would you rather get Stone Cold Stunned by Steve Austin, sharing a beer and whatnot? Or was it rock bottomed?
Yeah.
Or get rock bottomed by The Rock?
So my favourite wrestler was Bret the Hitman Hart. Because I loved wrestling back in the day. But then when it was the Attitude Era, when Hitman went to WCW, Stone Cold was my favourite. So I'd rather get stunned by him.
Sharing a beer, getting like...
100%.
If you could get any wrestling move done to you by that like person, who would it be?
Whatever Sables was. No. Ever get done to me?
Yes.
Yeah, so choke slam by the Undertaker.
Yeah. Choke slam rather than tombstone. I don't want to go 69 the Undertaker.
I don't want a 69 the Undertaker. No.
After a full match as well, everyone's dripping. It's like. Get my gooch. And I'm going to get
smell the tent.
No wonder the guy rolls his eyes after he flies.
That's just him passing out.
Just fucking steroids. And just... Well, it's been a fun one. Darren, thank you for joining us this week. We really want to have you back on again soon.
I will. No problem.
We have a lot lined up for the next few weeks. We're also getting game ready at the same time. We will try and make some games, as we have said, past podcasts. But as it stands right now, we are both getting ready for games. So I hope Lee is as well. Lee's getting ready to sit on the bench.
I'm there if you need me. If you don't need me, then I'm not there.
You'll be there to get footage.
Maybe.
You will.
You'll be there to get footage of other games for us.
Need more games.
But we have plans. We have another one of our coaches on in 2 weeks. Do I agree?
You haven't told me a time yet. Or a date.
We're waiting for him to get permission off the old... I don't think...
My co-founder.
Do you think she watches it?
No.
You know what I want? Because I know Lee watches it. But I think Lee'll absolutely express when we have him. But... We have Leon soon, and then we have a few other people who are all trying to get onto our podcast. So we'll have some faces here or somewhere else. But as of right now, this is home office because this is where Lee lives. And Lee has a lot of technology that you can't all see behind here.
Mm-hmm.
Also a lot of mess, but I don't judge.
I'm still sorting out this room. I've got a lot planned this weekend.
Is that fill in the holes. Hammer.
Put that up there today.
Well, you used a hammer
For the wall plugs.
Are they screws?
Yeah, for the wall plugs. Because it's drywall.
So you just don't use the back of the drill?
Just tap it up.
I I tried, it didn't work.
Well, that's Unsportsmanlike conduct. Thank you for watching. Give us a like, follow, whatever you want to do. Instagram, YouTube, and Instagram. That's Instagram, Facebook, I don't know. We will have some merchandise coming on soon for us, I'm sure.
I've teased the logo to Jack already.
The logo has been teased and is in production, so that will be out soon. And hopefully we'll be giving some of our merch and wearing some of our merch rather than this Darren Steam stuff. Sorry. So, yeah, thanks again, and we'll see you next week.
Take care, guys.